Welcome to your show number 550 entitled Flatbed Santa. We're kind of finishing up. People are in the lobby chit-chatting and hanging out, and that was a damn good one.
Buddy. That was a good show. Ross McCoy came by and hung out for the whole show. It was good having Ross sit in.
Make sure you get out to see that big comedy, I guess, showcase? What you want to call it? Mm. With probably 30 comics that you're never going to see all in one spot ever again. That's at the Bull and Bush. I'll put links in the show notes for you.
And I told some stories about the diaper dog that I almost adopted, and Castleberry Flatbed Santa.
Well, I went to Tijuana Flats with my daughter, and was proceeded to be like hammered with different people that I knew she would want to question loudly in front of them. So that was not fun.
Yeah, asked Ross for some parenting advice, just like old times.
Yeah, a couple of voicemails, and one happens to be an old man in his 80s being circumcised.
Yeah.
Why would you do that?
Yeah, so it's old school show today.
At
really
that point,
old school.
Shouldn't you just say, like, kill me? Just kill me. Mm-hmm. Don't circumcise me.
And it was a good one. I laughed a lot, and my literally voice is gone from talking and laughing.
Well, you've been sick, and you know what you need to do? You need to go home and hydrate, courtesy of Guardian Water Services.
Yeah, I'm glad you brought that up. GuardianWaterServices.com is the website to go to. You want to get those RO systems that Travis got. We both have. Yep. We have one in the studio.
We do.
Reverse osmosis water. They install underneath your sink, and it has its own spigot, and you got as pure as water as you could buy in the store.
It's the best water you can get. Yeah. And for somebody like me that likes to cook a lot, like, I honestly don't think... In fact, with my turkey that I brined for Thanksgiving, I used only the RO water, and I needed more, and I drained my RO tank, right?
Yep.
I refused to put tap water in there. Like, even though my tap water is probably pretty good, I just refused to put it in there.
100%. And if you want the full conditioning system for your house, they do that as well.
Yep.
That way it could save your pipes, all your appliances from the calcium deposits. Basically, you could have that full conditioning water even before it comes into your house.
Well, one of the best things about Guardian, too, and you're going to hear this later, well, actually, you'll hear it at the beginning of the show, is that they do a lot of work with the Yellow Brick Road Foundation, which is a charity near and dear to Tom and I's hearts.
Yeah.
They basically, anything where children are dealing with congenital heart defects, not being able to get out of their hospital bed, their hospital room, it can be really, really bad, and it can kind of kill the kids. Kids, you know, that little bit of spirit, that little bit of spunk. If you're just stuck in a hospital room all the time and you can't get out to see your grandparents or go to a garden or see some sunshine, it can be a bit of a downer.
Yeah.
Well, these wagons that Yellow Brick provides really, really do change these kids. It changes everything, the whole demeanor. We talked to a doctor, and he backed it up. You know, there's no way around it. Getting out of the hospital room is paramount.
Yeah, and Josh from Guardian Water Services, the owner, was with us when we delivered some wagons to Nemours Children's Hospital.
Well, nobody's done more than Josh. He won't say it, but I can say it.
Yeah,
and,
so
he's the best.
When you buy these full conditioning systems or the RO systems from Guardian Water Services, they donate a portion of that money to Yellow Brick Road. So they do good, and they do a great job with filtering your water. And they use Westinghouse products and stuff. So anyway, enjoy the show. We got Ross McCoy sitting in the whole show. It's good. It's a good one.
Yep. Strap on. Wait, strap on. Don't strap on.
Don't say strap on.
Put your strap on.
No, all right.
Live from the Streamline Mortgage Solutions Studio, it's Orlando's own Tom and Dan. Whoopee!
And we're back. What's up, everybody? Welcome to the show. It is A Mediocre Time with Tom and Dan. I am Dan.
I am Tom.
Samantha, our producer, is here. Hello, Sam.
Hello.
On the couch, I'm just going to let you do the honors. Two of the greats.
And I did laugh because right before the show, we're like going through the notes. We're like, what are we going to do first? We're going to promote the scratch-offs. And Ross's like, back to that again, huh? things have not gone well. Ladies and gentlemen, Ross McCoy. Hey. What's going on, dude?
They know you just said it during the intro.
I'm just still doing it. Yeah, but nothing's changed. But his face, got worse.
Yeah, but his face when you said, "Oh, well, the scratch off letter start," he was like, "Oh, God." You could see, see it. And then, of course, Bart. He's Bart Merrick sitting in with us a little bit today. Yeah, welcome, Bart. It's good to see you guys. But Bart, I think he's used to it by now.
Oh yeah.
I think he's used to the knuckleheadedness.
So what's going on, Ross?
Nothing much.
How have you been? How's life? How stand up?
He's got a popular podcast.
I know.
Yeah, you got 5 questions to answer, Ross. Go.
Yeah.
I just ask you all of the same. Well, nothing's changed.
Let's plug it real quick.
And the answer to all 5 is Fortnite.
let's plug it right off the bat because I was on it and I've actually been really enjoying it. And it's the Orlando Talk Show with Ross McCoy.
That's Tots. It. Hashtag Tots with Ross.
Tots with Ross.
Awesome. Yeah, Orlando based personal storytelling. Latest episode with Dan Stone, who does you guys' I saw that intros and stuff.
Yep. I saw Dan. I recorded after Dan. Can I talk freely about what?
Yeah, I think so. Unless Dan wouldn't want to say.
I think Dan would be okay with it. I don't think Dan cares. Right. But Dan got so high, he couldn't talk to me. and then he looked at me and he goes, "My ride is here." And then he walks out and he disappears into the night. And then the next day, or no, 2 days later, mm-hmm. I get a text from him that says, "Hey, dude, really sorry I couldn't talk." That's all it said. And I'm like, okay, well, you were, he was obliterated. I mean, just to the moon.
Yeah, it's rough when when a person with such experience, like Ross, with the THC, said, "Hey, you want to, smoke a bit?" Your sandals off.
Yeah.
Do you know what the real difference was? I think in that instance, and in an instance that happened to me this week earlier, I've fought with people before about the quality of Florida's weed.
Mm.
We're very lucky in this state for like outdoor grow conditions. You can get some really, really, really good weed here, especially in my experience compared to stuff in Georgia or like up north, like DC. Okay. Colorado stuff when it first came out was like really good.
Yeah.
I would put it up against Florida stuff. California has the fucking shit, dude.
If
you bump into somebody who's like, "I just got back from California and hey, try this," be prepared.
Yeah, it's ridiculous.
They have mountains.
Spicy.
There's some documentary about like they won't even let the police, like they control it. Like
weed
the
mountain.
Like the goddamn mafia.
Never talk about Weed Mountain.
And like they in the documentary, like the cops, they're like, "Oh, we're gonna escort you with like armed guards on 4-wheelers and up this weed mountain." Like they are growing mountains full of weed, and it's like there's no law. Like they're like above the law. It's bizarre.
Yeah,
they're on Weed Mountain. Of course, they're high in a number of respects. Of course, they're above the law.
Yeah, there's no laws on Weed Mountain. The White Claws, there are laws, but Weed Mountain, absolutely no laws.
So I'll plug this real quick because they're actually selling really well right now.
Yeah,
so
we were joking. We're joking around about the whole scratch off thing to earlier, but we actually have a really good charity component here that we're doing.
Yeah. So Yellow Brick Road, Juan Gonzalez, our Twitch manager, one of the founders of Yellow Brick Road Foundation,
inventor of the best mashed potato recipe of all time.
It worked for you, didn't it?
I made his mashed potato for Thanksgiving, and that was one of the few things that 100% across the board, I try to make potatoes every fucking year and nobody likes them.
Mm-hmm.
They're like good, but they're not great.
Yeah.
Juan's recipe, great.
Oh, yeah. He's an amazing chef. And he made us a Thanksgiving in a can.
It's Fieri Day.
Yeah, it is Fieri Day.
What does
that
mean?
It's a holiday that I think he invented where you celebrate everything that is Guy Fieri.
No, okay.
So you make
your most outrageous recipe you can think of.
Yeah.
And you share it
with friends and family. And then you share your recipes with people. And then I guess
to Bisto and Blondie. In the Facebook group.
Bisto and Blondie are doing a contest, so if you'd like to participate, you probably have a little bit of time now to, whip up something tonight. I'm going to try and throw my hat in the ring.
Me too.
I'm going to do something mac and cheese, because Maisie loves a mac and cheese, so I'm going to try to do something with that. Mm. Don't know where I'm going to go with that yet, though.
My kids don't like shit mixed into their mac and cheese. I thought, as a parent, like a tuna melt cast, a tuna helper was one of my favorite meals as a kid. Like, hot dogs and mac and cheese? Are you fucking kidding me?
That sounds amazing.
Yes,
right? Well, that's where I was going.
My kids don't like that stuff. They want the mac and then everything on the side.
Well, she'll fucking eat it. You eat one bite. Just try it.
So,
what would your kids do with the hot dog, Tom?
They eat the fake hot dogs.
Oh, no. Tell him.
Tell him. We haven't even talked about this on the show. Tell him about Sausage Gate. Breakfast Sausage Gate.
Okay.
Was it a breakfast sausage? Am I getting that wrong?
Yeah.
Are we allowed to talk about that, or am I fucking things up?
No.
I'm already fucking things up.
You're spilling all kinds of tea.
I'll tell you about the scratch offs.
Where's my Kermit costume? God damn it.
So I'll get to the sausage.
Arnold.
Get to the sausage. Get to the sausage.
About a dollar.
So we have this promotion going on right now, and it's Yellow Brick Road scratch off tickets, and they're $5. They're on TomandDan.com. Everything goes to Yellow Brick Road Foundation. We made it a goal. We try to raise $10,000 before the end of the year for Yellow Brick Road Foundation.
We're actually trending higher than that, which would be amazing if we could just, you know. Yeah.
So we
$10,001
raised $5,400 at the Beer Fest. Thank you for that. And we're trying to round out the year with this promotion. So one person's going to win a free Tom and Dan cruise for our next 2020 cruise. And then there's other subsequent prizes. You could win. There's a couple winners of $100 at TomandDanMerch.com.
Whose idea was that?
There was one. He told me. He was like,
$100? It's a lot of fucking merch.
And then there's a bunch of $20 winners. And so there's multiple winners, but one person's going to win a cruise.
Is there any zonks in there?
Whammy?
Yeah.
Oh, no, a whole bunch of nothing.
I want it like they scratch and they owe us money or something.
I mean, they kind of pre-owed you $5.
Yeah.
That's true.
So if you buy it, it all goes Yellow Brick Road. And
you guys
really
are trending high,
it.
By the way, because they just opened the Jersey Mike's by me and did a fundraiser for Yellow Brick Road. You're welcome.
Yeah.
That was
what's your poison there?
Dude, that fucking club they got there is legit, but I was surprised by and am now addicted to the chicken Philly. I was startled by how good that sandwich
was. Their Phillies are solid, man.
Yeah.
Like, you know,
the beef Philly is good. That chicken Philly is fucking crazy.
Yeah, they flat top it.
So Miami sub style.
Unfortunately, with our the way that we work here, like, you know, like in Publix, and look, I love Publix, but you know, you got the lady, she puts the onions on top of your meat, and then she just sticks it in that oven, and then it burns your bread on the top.
You know what's funny? I was joking, not joking. I've been there like fucking 25 times since they've opened, and they went through a couple grill people, and they finally were like, yep, we got the grill person.
Oh, they had to,
cycled them over like tomato and lettuce. They didn't like axe any heads or anything. Oh. They're just not the flippers.
You're not grill material. Exactly. You're prep material.
Exactly. Yeah, you can make it Mike's way.
I like it.
Jeff's not allowed on the slicer. Cut his finger, and blood
like the wrestler.
Yeah.
Oh my God, what a sad movie. Mickey Rourke is disgusting.
So earlier on this week, I think it was Wednesday, during the show, some of you may have listened. I got a text from my wife, and Ross, you'll think this is funny. So I get a text and said, like,
I'm not going to check off on it quite yet.
No, you're going to enjoy it. Trust me, it is. There's nothing that, if I remember correctly, there's nothing that you like more than seeing Tom in mental anguish. Just call me crazy. I think this is going to be right up your alley.
So
we can check the tape, but I believe the first thing I said was correcting Tom.
So I get a text, and it's from my wife, and she's like, I found a dog. And right off the bat, I was like, no! And then
it's like a greeting card. I found a dog, .. And then you open.
And so, and she was like, it was a small dog. I know it has an owner because it has a collar on, but with no like address or whatever. But
yeah, no tags.
Like it was a shock collar. And then, and
those are the best collars.
And so,
this dog broke out of detention.
Yeah.
Wow.
So,
it's a refugee. You got to save this dog.
And she's like, I picked it up, I took it to the house. And now I'm trying to find the owner. And then she showed me a picture of it. And she's like, oh, by the way, it's wearing a diaper as well.
And so I scream. I'm in here editing. So I scream to Tom. I'm like, wait, shock collar and a diaper. That's Bubba the Love Sponge's dog. I'm screaming.
It's number one stunt dog.
Yeah, it's his fucking intern. You better return that dog. Oh, that dog's tasing his balls. They're shitting in a diaper.
Some 90s
shit jack.
90s
that dog
radio
is responsible
hound.
For taping a personal people unit to a ceiling fan right now.
You know how hard it is? is for that dog to take his tiny little teeth and put that put the personal people meter in the watch winder and then wind the watch or plug it in. That fucking little dog.
And so
and then you're so, okay. I don't want to get ahead of myself.
I'll tell you.
I'm by the way. By the way, I'm crying laughing. Yeah. I'm screaming. I'm praising God, which I don't believe in, but I kind of was starting to because I was like, Christmas has come early.
Yep.
Tom has a piss dog with a shock collar on it.
Yeah, yeah. You were yelling out Piper the diaper dog.
Yeah, Piper the diaper. I was like, Piper the diaper. Like, yeah, we're going to do shirts. We're going to do everything. We're changing the world with Piper the diaper dog.
So here's what I'm thinking. I'm like, all right, well, and you guys are laughing. This is your new dog, blah, blah. And I was a little bit afraid of that, but then I was like, well, most likely if it had a collar on in my neighborhood, like someone's.
And a diaper.
Yeah. The diaper.
It didn't put the diaper on itself.
No, you don't know that.
This is not a Garfield comic. Animals in the street don't have costume changes. They take care of by themselves.
So I'm like, someone put a diaper on it, so it's got to be someone. We'll find the owner, and it's not going to... Because my biggest fear was I'm going to end up with this fucking dog, and because my wife will 100% never like take it back to... Like, if no one claimed it, she wouldn't take it to the pound and be like, sorry, or just throw it into the woods. It would be ours. Like,
I told her what Jason Voorhees would do, which is the old put it in a you put it in a pillowcase, you whack it against a tree. Yeah. Everybody knows that.
Jesus.
Everybody knows that's the easiest way to get rid of a little dog.
So I didn't know what kind of dog it is, and so I get home.
Well, I know what kind of dog it is. It's a trash person, pissing, and shock collar dog.
And
that's
so,
a classic Florida diaper dog.
And I get home, and
AKC
then,
recognized.
And it's my worst fear automatically because I get home and Tommy and Max are playing fetch with it. Laughing, rolling on the floor.
Tell everybody what they're fucking calling it because this is when I threw my phone.
Named it?
No, they named
this
it when
I
got
threw
home.
My phone and started laughing so hard that Maisie came running. She thought something was wrong because I was literally having an emotional fit.
And I could tell this dog is
Daddy,
older.
Daddy, can we keep Tiki?
No, it's better than that. It's better than that.
And so
it's so stereotypical and so boring.
So Tommy's throwing the ball for it and he's like, come here, Oreo. Called it Oreo.
Nice.
And so I'm like, no, don't name it. It's nothing. And I'm like, it's full of cancer. Like, I'm sorry, it's telling him
it's
that.
Lumpy, right?
Oh, all the lumps. It's lumpy and it yelps when you try to pick it up. Yeah. I'm like, it's cancer lumps.
That's
are already sore. That's real bad. Like, once they're sore, you got minutes.
That's that new Oreo lump stuff. That's not flying off the shelf.
So so they're playing with this dog and it's a tiny Pomeranian, right? And so
fucking Oreo.
So
I loved it.
Little black and white dog.
By the way, Tommy might be my son because the first thing Tommy says in the video,
I meant to tell you before. You
no, but he says
he is short.
He said he's shorter, and he said something very Daniel. It's running around in your couch in its diaper, acting fucking like a lunatic
dog. A lot of energy for an old dog.
And Tommy says, "Don't let it chew our pillows." And I was like, "That's my boy."
I thought Tommy was running around the couch in his diaper, and that was the proof that you were his dad. I'm sorry.
No, when he said, "Don't let it chew our pillows," I was like, "That's good. This boy has a sense of ownership.
Sure.
Taking care of his couch.
I gotta go clean my daddy's car. I'll be right back."
Yeah, exactly.
So I come home to this, and it's my worst nightmare because my sons are already like falling in love with the goddamn thing and calling it Oreo. And my wife, by the way, she had been talking about getting a dog like December 13th. She's like, December 13th.
That's how it happens.
She's like,
bingo, bango, boom.
December 13th will be Lena's 20-year anniversary when I got her, and this is a sign. It's Lena reincarnated. I'm like, Lena, this dog was born before Lena died. Well, it's just it's Lena's
is that
ghost.
Can you? Yeah, I guess you could. A little part of you, maybe?
So,
it's a small dog?
Boy, but a lumpy little cancer dog with a diaper and a shock collar is super on Lena. That is super on brand.
I know, but yeah.
I mean, if
you can't pick it up yelping, I'm like, it's time!
If you're collecting action figures in the Van universe, it certainly is one of the smaller characters, right? There's Lena, there's Diaper Dog, there's Paul, you know, there's that lady, there's Mr. Dr. Ghoul, there's Suntan Sally.
And by the way, I'm also thinking if this dog ends up being ours and it is full of cancer, my wife's not going to just go like any sane person, like, well, you know, put it down. No. Like, nothing we can do.
You're going to the dog. dog Mayo Clinic.
Chemotherapy. Yeah. I'll be transporting his medication in a radiation bin. Giving like thousands. I mean, this goddamn Pomeranian cost me thousands. Anyway, so I'm sitting there watching it. And I noticed the diaper, right? So it's not a regular diaper where it covers his butt.
It's an action diaper. It's a Louis Vuitton diaper.
It's like Rambo's headband around his dick, right? So it's literally just a headband.
Hold on, pause.
Rambo's headband.
It's red and paisley. No.
Is it out for blood? Like what?
The dog put it on in an action sequence with a fucking hunting knife.
Here's the thing. I know about dog diapers because Lena at the end of his life.
I know dog diapers. You, sir, are no dog diaper.
I was putting dog diapers on Lena when it totally lost its ability to. If poop was just falling out of its butt and the nanny was screaming, Idol's Mio, there's poo poo everywhere. So we had to put a diaper on Lena. But this diaper didn't cover the
butt.
I'm having
pre deja vu of you as an old man screaming at somebody. I put dog diapers on since 2007.
So, excuse me for a second, Ross. I have to put on my Rambo headband.
Okay.
So this diaper just goes around its back and then around just its dick, right?
That seems odd.
Not its butt.
A dick diaper.
And so I was like, I'm sitting there, and then my sister-in-law, my wife's sister, comes over, and I'm like,
oh,
what?
He's wearing Rambo's headband.
and I'm like, why? What is this? And then she's like, oh, we had a Pomeranian before. There are barkers and markers, and what they do
is a store.
She's like,
I listen to them in the morning.
Yeah.
Male Pomeranians will apparently just mark everything, so they'll piss on everything they see, little squirts of piss. Yeah.
By the way, that's called the I'm not re-signing my contract with Clear Channel scenario. That's exactly what you and I did.
So you have to put this...
We might be Pomeranians.
You have to put...
I'll leave.
You have to put this one-strap diaper around its dick so it doesn't mark piss your entire house.
I need this for my dog.
And
that's why you got to keep an open mind. As much as you know about dog diapers, you learn something.
Yeah.
You can always learn.
Learning
never stops.
It has to wear a shock collar because it just barks continuously all day long.
Yeah. It's actually to protect. I read about this last night after you said that.
It wasn't shocking them.
No, it doesn't, but it does teach them because I guess they can bark themselves to injury.
So then I got even
never
more
heard of that.
No, this dog definitely works for Bubba Lusper.
And Ross,
check it out.
His name is Lumpy.
You'll probably get mad at this just like I did. I was like, why would someone own this shit? Just like, you have to wear it, has to wear a diaper 24/7 and a shock collar. Like, why did you choose this breed of dog to own? Like, this seems like a giant pain in the ass. Like, shock collar and diaper on all times. Like, it's like I own a giant tarantula, but I have to put fang guards over it, and I have to give it drugs so it don't eat me, and then I have to put the shoes on its feet. It's not meant to be owned!
Yeah, Caesar can only wear a bikini and a foam cowboy hat, like, at all times.
And choose a another! That's a lot of shoes for a so many shoes.
I'm just saying, choose another pet. You're owning the biggest pain in the ass. Anyway, so
how about just drive by this thing in the street? How about that?
Oh, I would have.
So your son. Just to recap. Now I want to throw some things out here and maybe getting us. I'm feeling spicy.
Getting
some trouble.
Worse, I'll tell you.
I got a picture from Tom who is holding said soccer ball and moving it back and forth. And you said to me, Oreo likes to play tug of war.
I was just fucking around
sure.
Well,
I thought maybe diaper dog had worn you down a little bit.
No, that was my first thought. Hilarious joke.
Yeah. He's joking.
It's funny because I told you how much I hated it. Anyways.
And he won you over.
No, he didn't.
You're calling him by his name.
Yeah. You didn't call him Oreo. His name was not Oreo.
Hey, Dan, check out these hilarious JCPenney portraits of me and Oreo. They're so funny. Ironically.
The dog's real name was Lindsey Graham. That's an odd name for a dog.
So the dog's sitting there. My sons are playing with it. And my wife tells me, well...
Every second they play is bad for you. You know that, right?
I love Oreo. He makes me itchy.
She took the dog up to the vet to see if it had a chip, right? And it did have a chip.
But it was a chocolate chip.
But it was...
stuck to the top of its head.
It was fucking unregistered. So like the vet,
what does that even mean?
So the vet's like, oh, it has a chip, but it says registering is unregistered, so it's blank.
It was actually a Boost Mobile SIM card.
And I'm like, unregistered? I'm like, why even make it? So, like, just give me the last owner. Like, have that information always on there just so that I can call someone.
The dog does have great Wi-Fi.
I had no idea that you could get a blank chip put in your dog.
Why did they do it?
That's the dumbest thing I've ever heard of. It's almost like giving somebody a blank check and going, no, 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 you fill it out. You fill it out. I put your name on there.
The whole point is like putting LoJack on your car and be like, you didn't register. No, that we had no way. So unregistered chip, and then so my wife.
Oh my God! Hold on. Twitch chat room, twitch.tv/TomandDanLive. Just to piggyback on what you're saying, Matt says people do that shit. I found two dogs with unregistered chips. You can find out who put the chip in, though. That's the only thing you can find out.
No, they did not give us that information.
Maybe they put it in themselves.
They were like, we got nothing.
Bit of a hobbyman.
So then my wife goes old school, and she's like, I'm gets on
she
our bicycle.
She started breakdancing on cardboard. I'm like, why are you? Fucking, you're doing a head spin on cardboard. I'm trying to fucking find Oreo's hole. The fuck are you doing? Stop pop locking for a second and get serious.
And she gets on her bicycle and prints out a bunch of.
She did go old school.
Tell me she got on her bike.
Yeah.
I mean, you say bicycle. It was technically a penny farther.
After
right?
Digging it out of trash in my garage.
That's her. Who makes it? Denali?
No. We sold
Chevy,
those.
The Chevy bike?
No, it was some old Dick Sporting Goods bike.
They bought it was like a bike made by the person you would never want to make a bike. It was like
Guy Fieri.
Yeah. A beach cruiser. Anyway,
bought and returned a Dick Sporting Goods bike on Black Friday. The same day.
So I did get out of the trash.
One ride, not for me.
She prints out a bunch of like lost dogs. She takes a picture, whatever.
Oh man, you are really, really married to a wonderful person. The fact that she would put that time and effort into it is so sweet.
And she pedals off to go put the
was
lost
she dressed
dog
like the Flying Nun, like sitting sideways on the bike.
There was a witch vibe of it to my mind.
And I know what you did. As soon as she took off with the flyers on her bike, you're like, how long do I have to drag?
Now, so she takes off and then puts flyers, comes back, and I'm like, well, someone is going to claim this, like, because this dog is obviously someone's, and the first thing they're going to do is start searching the neighborhood, find the flyer, we'll get this thing out of here in no time, right? So hours go by. It keeps going by. Nighttime
falls.
Well,
I was getting more and more texts, more pictures, the boys, he's playing with the boys.
Oh, yeah, and by this time, it's probably like it's 7 o'clock at night, and I'm like, fuck. I'm like, because in my mind, I was like, the person gets home from work at 5, like, notices the dog's gone, and then searches the neighborhood. They must
and then they're like, I'm free.
No more diaper. And the shock collar. My God. They're like,
this dog knows. I feel like this dog does, like, he could tell Crystal's, like, MO or how she is. And you're right.
You think so?
I think this dog probably knew it was only a couple hours away from no more collar, no more diaper, like, literally living the dream.
And then my sister-in-law, my wife started telling me, they're like,
oh, by the way, that's the worst combo you could ever have for anything animal related is the two of them because their powers combine. It's almost like some sort of weird fucked up X-Men. It's like, well, when they're together,
they're already laughing. Believe me, the dog is running up and sitting on my lap and they're taking pictures. They're like, look how happy he is. I'm mad. And they're like, he likes you.
Crystal sent me this.
By the way, the boys are tired of it real quick. as soon as I turned on Aladdin, but that goes into my next
you're
part of the
story. You're using distraction techniques.
Yeah.
He's got a monkey. That's not fair.
That's true.
Yeah, you're like, look, boys, fireworks in December.
And she's got a tiger. Fucking Oreo can't stack up against either of their pets.
So,
but like all good kids have sex or whatever. So like,
I thought that was Lion King.
Might have been Lion King. Was Oreo dust, whispering anything weird?
My wife and sister-in-law started telling me, they're like, oh, you know, this is a thing where sometimes when people can't afford or take care of dogs anymore. Or
they put
has
diapers on. They release them into the streets.
Or they deregister the chip and kick them out of their car.
And they're like, they take it to neighborhoods and they just drop their dog off thinking that someone in the neighborhood will find it and start taking care of it. I'm like, what?
I'm like, that's a thing. And they're like, oh, yeah, that's a thing.
It is a thing, unfortunately.
They'll drop it off in people's neighborhoods. And I'm like, what?
Not even the courtesy of an orphan note, huh?
But I was like,
a little note pinned to his collar.
I was like, what?
It's a shot collar. Set the note on fire, and he burns alive.
And they're like, especially if they know it has cancer, that they'll drop it off in a neighborhood hoping that some other person will spend money on
somebody does that with me when I get cancer. Like, I hope they just drive me into a really good neighborhood, just throw me out of the car like a gang shooting.
I'm like, do they think people are going to be like, oh, here's my cancer dog, and immediately start treatment on it, or put it to sleep? Like, here, put
cut
my dog
to Crystal at the vet, getting the dog cancer treatment immediately.
You're right.
I think they laser treatments again.
It's almost like a car without a Carfax. I almost feel like they think, well, we know it has cancer. If we drop it off, I mean, cancer's not visible, so maybe somebody will like care for it.
So
until it starts bleeding out of its ass all over your carpet, like my dog who had leukemia, the Dalmatian, and it was a violent, horrible way to go out. So the whole cancer thing, fucking not good.
So I
myth busted.
I thought cancer was cool.
No, I proved it. Okay. I proved it.
So
Isley just went full on. Isley just went 100 miles an hour until he died.
This is where my night takes a turn. You're not going to expect this.
Wait,
so,
did you say turn or turn?
Oh,
so
are you working for BuzzFeed now?
So I'm like, I decided.
Hold on, I got to click through.
Yeah,
I still have a cold, but my cold was kicking my ass on Wednesday. Yeah, you guys know, like, really I felt bad. Like shit.
You're really bad.
So I'm sitting there. My wife's like, well, it's like 7:30. It doesn't seem like the owner's going to call us today. We're going to have to settle in for the night. I'm going to go to Pet Supermarket.
Settle in for the night. You're not in wagons. You have a fucking house.
Circle the wagons.
You're not like, well, we've been traveling. This looks about like a good place. Stop. Dr.
High
dog.
Ground. There's a creek nearby.
Jerry, you start a fire. Mama, you collect the kids. Get everybody through the normal chores. I'm going to take a walk with Oreo and see if we can straighten out this diaper dog tip.
So my wife's like, I have to go to Pet Supermarket. I got to get food.
Yes.
I gotta get a dog bed. I gotta get new diapers.
Jesus Christ.
All the diapers.
And then some toys. And when I'm going to Pet Supermarket, settling in for the night. She takes off, right?
Oh, yeah. On her bike.
So,
weird.
So she leaves. And
she comes home with all that plus a hamster.
Yeah. So at this point.
Wearing a diaper.
A little bit. I found it. I'm sick with a cold. I'm like, I'm pissed off about this goddamn diaper dog. And I'm like, well, sons, let's they never watched Aladdin, so we got Disney Plus, then I'm like going through the archives, so I'm like, we're gonna turn on Aladdin, and then in an effort to knock my cold out, I was like, you know that
I'm gonna get fucked up.
And Ross,
the like, old whiskey cure.
No, not whiskey.
It kind of matches the whole Western theme we've gotten here.
I think we've talked about this. We all got our medical marijuana license, so now
what?
It's free THC. Not free.
I've been meaning to.
It's illegal.
I've been meaning to correct. It's a recommendation. Yeah. Not correct. A license.
Oh, whatever.
Yeah. Oh, because I was going to say, you can drive around a weed cart. It's cool.
Well, you can get some concentrate.
I have my learner's permit.
Some of the finest
concentrate. You can only smoke weed in front of your mom?
I have to have my mom in the in the passenger seat while I'm smoking.
The finest indica concentrate that Zerterra can make. And
I'm surprised you tooted.
It is strong. I ingest it.
You put your vape pen in your ass?
No, I take
it. I ingest it too and then blow it out my nose. It's cool, dude.
I eat the straight up concentrate. And this time I was like, I'm sick. And my theory being, I was going to kill the cold virus with THC.
I thought you were
going
to kill Oreos.
No. I'm going to get so high. I kill this dog.
Because I was like, didn't they say, like, if you were able to smoke like a dump truck full of weed in 1 hour, it would technically ODU, whatever, like impossible to do, but like
I know a guy who might try.
So, but I, my theory was like, well, the equivalent of a dump truck of weed to a human is like two long rice grains of indica, the most powerful indica that Zerterra makes. To
so
my
you
cold
did the math
virus
on how to kill yourself, smoking weed,
not kill myself, then, kill my cold virus.
Oh, yeah.
So I was like, if I get all Walter, you know, like rev it to the max, then this is, you know, plus I'll forget about this dog, whatever. So I take my double dose of indica.
Well, your boys are still there and probably need some daddy in too. So
no, that's the end of the night. Okay. They're fine.
Fair enough.
And my wife's coming home later. She, it'll
so
all
if
good.
You're like freaking out,
something happened.
Freaking out. Ross knows you can do everything high, no problem.
But edibles are different for different people. Like there are people that I won't let do edibles around me anymore because
it's kind of like that to me too. But I've learned how to. Daniel taught me how to ride the lightning, and as long as you keep the anxiety attack from happening and chaos.
Yeah, the
is not
reality
going...
of it is, I do like getting way too high because I can control that anxiety. Yeah, but my real anxiety, which I know you've all of us here have seen my real anxiety, I can't control that very well. So I don't know why that I enjoy that. Like when I get way too high with scary high. I love it.
So,
I love it.
So you have established guidelines that you know you can keep it within, and you decide to double that.
I double it, but I'm like, well, it's the end of the night. I'm sick and weak. Yeah, sick and weak.
I'm watching my kids.
All of this adds up. My sister-in-law's there. It's fine.
Oh, she was there still? Playing with the dog?
Yeah.
You didn't say that. Okay, great. Yeah, get fucked up.
Traumatize Alex, by all means.
It's fine. No one knows what's happening in my mind. You know, like to me, everybody's like, oh, it's probably normal, but I'm on the brink of anxiety.
When I got the photo of you playing with the miniature tennis ball with quote, Oreo loves to play tug of war. Were you
playing?
Okay. So that makes sense then. The weed calmed your anger.
I'm watching Aladdin. It was great. I'm like telling my son.
That Robin Williams going to be something.
And then I get a call. And it's my wife. And she's like, quick, get up. Santa's driving down the street. And I'm like,
what?
And so I'm like,
you're like, I'm really
stoned as fuck. And then you hear Santa's driving down the street.
And then I'm like, what? And then she's like,
but you live in Castleberry, so she must have meant safe.
And so I'm confused by this, right? Obviously. And then I'm getting up in my own head, and then it starts ramping on my side. Because what have you done
with my wife? Have I been a naughty boy?
Because I'm like, what are you, like, because then I'm confused, and my wife's like, what are you talking, just like, get up, get out of here, Santa's out here, he's coming down the road.
Well, what are you guys doing with Oreo?
And so then, I'm like, what are you talking about? Because then I started getting scared that I'm like, wait a minute, is she making perfect sense, and I'm too high to make sense of what she's saying? I'm like, because now I'm like, am I lost my mind?
I've had those inner dialogues. Yeah.
Because then I'm like, dude, I don't want to tell her how high I am, or that I'm inebriated. No.
Sometimes I just want to hide. I just like close my eyes and I'm like,
you could have used the cold as an excuse though.
Yeah, because I was like, I'm on. I was also on NyQuil. Like, you know,
that's a fun ride. You should have run to the bedroom and then put the covers on you and pretend to shiver or something.
So
too much weed and NyQuil. That's the recipe.
Yeah,
so
go.
I'm in a different world and I'm like, what? And what's going on? She's like, Santa. Like, he's on
You're
a flatbed.
Going to school with Dwayne?
He's being
Castleberry Santa.
Santa's on a flatbed and being police escorted by the Castleberry police, and he's going from town to town.
I hope he didn't come over here because we don't want him.
If it was Big Tim, I have bingo.
And I'm like, what? And she's like, get out of here. I'm like, we gotta chase him.
Santa.
So I'm like, kids, get out.
What's Oreo doing?
That Oreo's playing with my sister-in-law. I'm like, okay. And then so my wife pulls up and she's like, get in the car, get the boys in the car, we gotta chase down Santa.
Chase him down. And to be fair, she was riding a reindeer.
And she's like, he just came out of the apartment complex, the one at one wheel.
Only the fanciest Santa.
And so I hear the cop cars and stuff, and like, and the lights in the distance. And
I'm like, Santa, please pull over, end this now, you can still save lives.
I want to kill people.
And then so I'm like, what the fuck is going on? I've never even heard of this, right? So
he's coming out of the apartment complex. So he's like, goodbye, single mom. So good to see you.
I get in the truck. I buckle my sons. I sit in the passenger seat.
Well, at least you had the wherewithal to do that.
And my wife's like, we got to go. He's going down the street. And she...
how fast can he be going? He's on a fucking flatbed. It's not like he's in a Maserati or something.
We roll down on the windows, and we stop the car at the stoplight, and we're trying to listen to where we're hearing police sirens and then Santa music. And I'm at this point, I'm freaking the fuck out.
Yes.
Like, I am, my anxiety, I was like, calm watching Aladdin, like, this is the life. Didn't even care about Diaper Dog anymore. I'm like, I'm, and then now I'm sitting in the car, fucking panic attack on 10, because I'm like, what are we doing? What do we have? What's happening?
Zombie apocalypse. Yeah.
I'm like, I'm freezing. I'm like, I'm in my,
we have all the windows down.
I like I'm in the sweatpants and tight
t-shirt.
Tom and Dan shirt.
No, that's allowed. That's Castleberry. And, I like the idea of your wife, too, going like, and handing you a gun. Say, here, you're going to need this.
And so,
if I was dead sober and my wife told me, woke me up and told me we were hunting the Easter Bunny, I would have questions.
Yes, yeah, right. Yeah.
So she hands you a gun. She's like, you ever used one of these before? You're going to need to.
So I'm freaking out.
Game
because
face on.
I'm like, what is it? And she's like, we're going to go. We go down and we get on Lakemont. Mm-hmm. And then they're there. I see police lights, a fucking fire truck leading the way, and a flatbed semi truck. Oh, and now this is from far away, and there's Santa and Mrs. Claus on, and then the
help,
like, reindeer.
Help, get us off this truck. We've been kidnapped by hillbillies.
They're on the sleigh, and then Castleberry police, lights, and everything, and then we're chasing now down.
I don't think
Lake
you're supposed to do that.
This fucking Santa, panicked, by the way. I'm freaking out.
What are the boys doing?
They're like, oh, they're happy because they're like, oh, what's going on? You know,
is it
kids
a good Santa, like with a real beard or fake beard?
Dude, it's a legit Santa. Now, it's far, and then they're going down, and there's a bunch of cars doing the same shit. They're all, apparently, if you
bring... People know of the Castleberry Flatbed Santa.
I didn't know.
In Twitch.
I have no idea.
If you're watching us on Twitch, twitch.tv/TomandDanLive, people are saying they used to throw candy. People know of the, Castleberry Flatbed Santa.
I've never seen this before. I've lived here for, like, 9 years, never seen Castleberry Flatbed Santa, but apparently...
CFS is what he likes.
And so... Then he turns into another apartment complex, right? So we miss him.
This looks like a great place.
So my wife.
What do you mean you miss him?
Well, because there was a bunch of cars following him too, and so we were too far to show the boys. Like they see the back, but it's probably like 200 yards away.
Oh, wait a minute! All of that, and you guys didn't even fucking get to see Santa.
Well, wait for it.
Bullshit.
So then my wife's
Duke
like,
"Boys are about to pull it."
So and then they freeze it midair.
So then my wife's like, all right, we're going to pull down this street to the
we're
left.
Gonna pull down my top and show Santa my titties. Then he'll come back. Like, wait a minute. You don't need to do that.
Castleberry Santa love titties. So
those are great hardos.
So she's like, we're going to go down the street and wait for him to come back out because he's got to come out of the apartment complex.
So you're going to be waiting for hours, though.
Yeah. So we
a lot of apartments.
We go down a street next to the apartment complex. We turn around, and then now we're
we
just
set up our cow traps.
We're waiting now.
We're
other,
hiding behind a boulder.
Apparently, other people in Castleberry know because they're like on the street corners.
How do you not know? You're the king of Castleberry.
I have no idea. So we're sitting there waiting for Castleberry Flatbed Santa to come back out of the, and my sons are super excited. They're like, we all see Santa, and I'm freaking out still, but trying to keep it together and not tell my wife how extremely high I am and having a panic attack.
You didn't need to tell her that. You could just be like, I don't feel good, or this NyQuil is really fucking me up.
All right. And so I'm just sitting there.
Do you ever go,
silent.
Honey, can you drive? Do you want to make your wife drive?
She's driving. I'm not driving. I'm with my kids high.
Yeah, like if we're going out, like I'm going to Gringo's or something, I'll be like, hold on, I want to make my tacos taste better. Can you drive? You know, I do a little bit of that.
I'm just sitting in the passenger seat with my arms folded, just staring straight.
So Oreo's at the house with your sister-in-law. Okay.
So all of a sudden we hear the sirens and then the fire truck
are they
leading
playing
the
music?
Way.
Like ding, ding,
oh,
ding,
yeah, yeah.
Ding,
music
ding.
Is blasting. Ding, 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 and the,
it was Little Pump for some reason.
And then so now we see the lights and shit and my sons are like, oh, he's coming.
They're really just pulling you over to tase you for being overly high.
And then the fire truck comes out of the apartment complex, starts going down the street, and my wife pulls up to
block the way.
Well, we expect Castleberry Flatbed Santa to keep going straight, and little did we know that the fucking fire truck and then their route was on the same road that we were waiting on, and there was a car parked next to us, and my wife wanted a good view, and so now all of a sudden there's a fire truck, Castleberry Flatbed Santa, and a bunch of cops. And all lights on. The fire truck has its siren.
And then and all of a sudden,
it's too much.
I'm freaking out.
That was freaking the fuck out of me if I saw that many lights and the sirens going on.
And then all of a sudden it turns onto the street that we're on that we're now blocking the goddamn way. And then the fire truck's like, God, like with this loud ass fire truck horn. And I'm like, no, I'm like, back up, get out of here. And then they're honking at us. Well, now we're blocking the fucking route of Casaberry Flatbed Santa. So
I don't know, Rick, this is a bad idea. We gotta get out of here.
The firefighters are like, get out of here. they're waving us to get out.
You're stopping Flatbed Santa.
And then I'm like, go. And then so
there's actually some kids trapped in the chimney. Santa's the only one that can save them.
So my wife has to pull up over the median to get out of the way of Casaberry Flatbed Santa. Whatever it is. And then Santa
it was a medium.
Santa just,
no, she ran over Cindy Kaza.
My sons are like, Santa! As he comes by, they're mad that we're blocking the goddamn way. Like,
don't get in my way, motherfucker! Your family's idiots!
And then they proceed down the street, and then my wife's like, that was great. I'm fucking panicked. At this point, my heart is beating so fast, and I'm like level 12 anxiety attack.
Now you know what I feel like every night.
I know.
Every night when I close my eyes, I see Flatbed Casaberry Santa. He's right there with fucking flames in his eyes. It's torturous.
Do you think when the Sanford police and fire department drive him around, he shouts out their names like he does the reindeer? On Cletus, on
Oreo. Oreo with your diaper so filled, won't you guide my flatbed?
So
got nothing to rhyme with it.
So we get back home, and then I'm like, I sit down on the couch, anxiety, and then little Oreo jumps up on my lap.
Your only friend.
And I'm petting Oreo like my son's on it, and then it brings the little ball to me.
Theme
And you're so high, he looks at you and he's like, that flatbed Santa. That shit fucking sucks.
And then wife gets a call, and it's the owner. And they're like, we're missing, I don't know what the
Nitro.
Nitro.
It was something aggressive.
And they're like,
he's a cancer pommy.
They're like, we were at our friend's house, and then
we were
both
chasing
our dogs.
Flatbed Santa, and our dogs got out because of all the commotion.
So all the food, the little dog bed, everything, that was like $58.
Yeah. I woke up to a text saying, do you need a new dog bed for Caesar? That's what I woke up to. The text I woke up to.
And the owners came, and they're like, little whatever it is. I'm like, his name is Ori.
you're already like one tear down your cheek.
Yeah. He likes playing balls.
Did you propose setting him halfway between you guys?
Well, at that point, I was...
You would need a king in order to declare, right? Like, all right, let's see who he goes to.
And then my wife found the these people's other... They lost two dogs at the same time.
They lost a basset hound, too.
I'm like, you are the worst dog owners.
One of our listeners said the funniest thing. The listener's like, losing a basset hound is like losing your pet rock. You know, like, it's like, how do you fucking lose that? That's the slowest, sweetest dog ever.
And apparently she found the basset hound because she was on that Nextdoor app or whatever, and someone put up like, hey, found a basset hound, and then these people didn't know about Nextdoor. My wife made the
connection.
That's
the only good thing Nextdoor's ever done. Yeah. Most of it's just black person rang my doorbell. Black person rang my doorbell. Hey, there's a brown person ringing my doorbell. Now this is weird.
Mm. So that was my experience with
fucking
that was
horrible.
My night with Piper the diaper.
Piper diaper.
And it was you, Oreo.
Yeah.
Now were the boys at all? Serious question. Not at all trying to be entertaining. Were the boys at all like? Sad.
They didn't give a shit. My wife was like, good for you.
My wife was like,
she was like, you want to come out and say the last goodbye to Oreo? And they're like, no, we're watching finishing Aladdin. They don't give that was my point. I was like, you want a dog? They don't give a shit.
You know how you can be the fucking hero though is a little puppy for Christmas, dude.
They were talking about that. We know
Jason, the Sony rep for the West Coast.
Okay,
you know, and I'm trying to get him to get an Aibo, the robot dog.
because they re-released it again. Like every few years,
Ibo's back.
Yeah, they'll bring him back. You're the perfect candidate for an Ibo.
Dude, if they could put a Baby Yoda head on that fucking thing, a million units.
Yeah, I'm fine with Robot Dog because you could. My whole problem is that when you leave, anytime we want to do anything on the weekends, dog sitter, fucking dog.
I got bad news for you, Robo Dog, Electro Diaper.
Yeah. Same problem.
Just more
than change, you got to turn it off first. Yeah. You turn that thing off. It's like an electrician.
Robo Dog. It's a water collar.
Yeah.
If you don't turn that thing water,
off, blow your eyeballs out.
All right. Let's take a break. I'm sweating now.
I turned the air on. I noticed it. I turned the air on.
Yeah.
I
still got the cold. So I'm going
to
take
a
shot.
Good to know. Let's invite everybody, including Ross in here. Give them everybody a cold.
Sorry.
Yeah. We'll take a little break. This is new music from the band Rat Boys. Yeah, I think it's a girl. I think it's girls. 1-844-TOM-NDAN if you want to call. Show at TomandDan.com if you want to drop an email. We'll be right back with more A Mediocre Time right after this.
American Air and Heat came to both of our houses to design our brand new systems for our house because I know that you have an older system.
I need some help because I have multiple levels, and I think we're going to go like maybe even a little more smart home style.
Yeah.
Because it's pretty difficult to have to run up and down and manually change all of these thermostats in order to get the correct temperature on my townhome. So, yeah, I'm really excited. And their techs are amazing. Absolutely amazing. Not only are they efficient, not only are they in uniform, polite, and kind, and the type of person you want to, you know, come and want to come into your home, but they're really quick. My wife had to do it on a lunch break, like the actual walkthrough. Boom, super fast.
When they came over, and we have our return where it sucks in the air next to our couch when we watch TV. It's loud every time. So every time we're watching a movie, we turn off the AC because
that sounds lovely. My God, man. So, really? You sit there and sweat while you're watching The Grinch?
And our AC bill is like $350 in the summer. It's insane. It's because our air conditioning unit is 10 years old.
Oh, my God,
no, it's crazy.
$350?
So when we talk to American Air and Heat, they're like,
they
man,
laugh.
They're the new systems are so efficient. Yeah. It's going to save you money. So you're going to save money on an electric bill. And they said, like, oh, we'll cap off this return and then just put all the returns in your ceiling. It'll make it more efficient and therefore it won't be so loud when you're watching TV. It's like, oh, okay, perfect. And they make sure all the ducts are right. They make sure the air is flowing in your house correctly.
Yep.
That way you're the most efficient, so you're not spending a ton of money on your electric bill every month because you could be spending that on a new system.
Well, you can finance it too, which is really, really nice.
And they make financing super easy. 36 months, no interest. So you can get a new system, have them come design it, save money, and then pay no interest for 36 months. Also, if you have a system that's shoddy or needs some work, give them a call. They've got 24/7 availability. They're not going to charge you extra for weekends or off hours other companies.
And believe me, we've had to do that sort of stuff, you know, and like everybody knows what it's like. And plus, if you're going to do any type of preventative maintenance, now would be the time to do it because we have some cooler weather. So right now, if they're going to get in there and root around, you want them doing it when you don't necessarily need your air. But guess what? Summer's coming.
It's
going to come hot, hot, hot.
24-point preventative maintenance check. That's just $74.95. So if you have any AC problems or you want complete new units, like me and Daniel are going to get, go to AmericanAirAndHeat.com. It's family-friendly service. That's American Air and Heat.
Scumbags! What's going on? It is Sam and Trav with your BDM Clip of the Week, Sam.
And Trav.
We are just coming off Thanksgiving weekend.
Fuck yeah, we are.
And the BDM show, we all recap what we did this Thanksgiving, and Dan had a story that might suggest the orb has moved on to him.
Let's check out the clip.
I'm just like, something felt weird. Like, I was like, something's wrong. You know, this has been too long. So I just happened to, I had a Crispy Boy again.
It's like, is that
breakfast
the golf
Crispy Boy?
Is that my golf cart with what looks like Danny Trejo? Where's my family?
All right. So I go outside and I see coming running towards me, Maisie crying.
Okay. Oh.
A lot of crying.
Anytime your kid's running without the,
no shoes,
the person watching them crying, something real bad happened.
Mommy's dead. Yeah. So Maisie's running to me. She's covered in fucking rocks and sand. And I look and I see Andrea like running towards me, and she's covered in rocks and sand. And apparently, my wife driving the golf cart and like doing being the old drunky junior over here took a corner. And the right front monster truck wheel came unhinged and shot out into
my head. Oh, you lost a wheel? Oh,
and then the whole fucking golf cart flipped. Would they get ejected?
No.
They get ejected into the fucking coquina rocks. And then there's this, and shout out to Ben, who was at the Ocean Resort, and some larger redneck man. He's using a log to try and jack it up because, like, it looks like he's pinned underneath it.
I see the problem here. There's a fryer basket stuck in the wheels.
Man, there is nothing worse than when you're planning for the holidays and just everything seems to be going wrong.
Yeah, I feel like that happens a lot, though.
Yeah, well,
people are stressed out.
That's the orb. Transitioned the orb to Dan.
Well, to hear the rest of this story and everybody else's Thanksgiving, you need to sign up to become a BDM.
At TomandDan.com.
Don't do me like that. You like the Tom Petty?
Never got into Tom Petty.
Wow.
He's Florida's own, Tom.
Yeah. Nice. I like Free Fallin' for karaoke.
Yeah, I do like some, Free Fallin'. Welcome back to A Mediocre Time with Tom and Dan. I am Dan.
I'm Tom.
Samantha, our producer's here. We have Butler here. We have special guests that are sitting in. Bart Merrick is here, or did he leave?
No, he's my ride. So
okay, so Bart is here. Our good friend Ross McCoy is here from Tots with Ross.
Hey, guys.
The Orlando Talk Show. If you do not subscribe, if you have not heard it, please do. Go check it out. I think you'll really like it.
Yep.
It's a damn good show, but why wouldn't it be? It's only like you've been on, I don't know, hundreds, if not thousands of podcasts, so why wouldn't it be good? And I'm on there on, I'll be coming up sometime.
Like
soon.
Two, not this coming Thursday, but the Thursday after that.
Yes.
It's a Dan-cember on the Orlando Talk Show with Ross McCoy. It's all Dan's in December.
Yeah.
Dan Stone and Dan Dennis.
Latest episode, Dan Stone.
It's really good.
Really, really cool. It's good to see that guy.
Did you ever hear about that guy before Dan brought him up, the Glenn Rogers guy or whoever? Well, I can't remember the name.
Neil.
Okay.
Neil Rogers.
Okay.
In Miami, the talk show host?
No.
Am I getting it or no?
This was a local guy and he did like motivational speaking, but he had a hair lip.
A radio guy?
He might have dabbled in radio. He came to Orlando. He kind of got like involved with selling makeup. He started his own like kind of Amway style multi-level marketing makeup setup. And then he's like, I'm you know what I'm really good at is selling. So he kind of became like a Tony Robbins here in Orlando. This is all like in the 60s or 70s or something. And going into whenever Dan Stone moved to town, the guy was still around and doing like motivational speaking. But as I mentioned, he had a hair lip.
No.
Oh, man.
So, how did that work?
I listen to Thoughts with Ross.
No. So,
Great plug.
So, we were going to talk about this because Ross was actually there the first time it happened. It finally...
Yeah, I told the Rolling Stones not to hire the Hells Angels. They did not listen. Yeah.
Well, what was it? Yesterday?
Yeah.
Did you guys do comedy to highlights?
Samantha walked in on me while I was peeing.
It happened. Yeah. The tables have turned. I want it to be known that we did buy a sign to put on the door that says occupied.
I thought that was for you.
Okay. Well, that's for everybody.
Transparency, I used it the first 2 weeks. I have not
used it every time now.
I don't use it anymore.
Mm. A lot of places do this thing, and you might want to look into this. They have a lock on the door.
Right.
Lock works now. I fixed it, but nobody trusts it, so then we needed a stick-on sign.
Well, the door is kind of fucked up. You have to really pull it in to actually click it in. Otherwise, you can have the door locked all you want, and you can still open the fucking door, because that's what happened to me last time.
Well, I didn't know that.
So, our door locks now does not track well in court either, by the way.
Like, even our front door lock is like that. Like, if you really wanted to get in here, you just jiggle it. It will open. And then if you want to shut the security system off, it's $69.69.
Cut, everybody knows. Cut that out. And the thing about Dan Stone smoking.
Everybody knows.
So he didn't use the sign. He didn't lock the door.
Yeah. And no. Then Samantha did the cartoon, I throw everything I have in my hands up because I'm so shocked. Yeah, she's like, yeah! And then ran off. And
I was like, what the fuck, man? And he's like, I thought you could hear me peeing. And I was like, I didn't hear anything.
She's like, why were you holding that cancer dog?
I thought the sink was dripping.
I pee loud.
Yeah, she did say that. Because his prostate is, I mean, it is big, big.
Oh, and, red
and
hot.
Now it's a whole the scenario.
The only thing she could have said was, I thought somebody was making orange juice.
Oh, yeah.
Couldn't you hear me screaming? I scream like I've been shot out into Mars when I have pee-pee.
Let me ask you guys.
Now it's even, like, and we're good to go.
Ross is...
Are we? I don't know.
In court, I think that's how it works.
Wait, the judge goes, well, you walked in on him, he walked in on you, we're striking the whole male dancer, groping you, we're taking that
it's
off.
It's like offsetting penalties in the NFL.
Penalty decline.
Although I will say that when Tom walked in on me, Ross warned him,
yeah,
and he still opened the door.
I almost tried to tackle him. It was like everything short of a tackle.
I told Samantha, I was like, he's in there. And his prostate swollen. Open the door on him and freak him out. He'll really fuck up his day. He already feels bad. Go fuck up his day. Mm.
And if this does come down to Judge Judy, I'm going to say that Sam's ahead about like 150,000 take your pants off.
It was a different time.
Anything goes.
It was a different time.
A male stripper.
It's 2017. As, you know, pre Me Too, all this stuff.
The only thing you have comparable is that lady at Johnny's who slung mustard over the whole crowd.
Oh my God, situation. I forgot about that lady.
I feel very confident she is dead. I feel very confident with the way she was living.
I forgot about that. Oh yeah.
I think she got her shit together after that. Now she's working at Jersey Mike's.
She's doing a sandwich Janis Joplin the way she was.
Oh, that's old sandwich making contest. That was pretty. The Real Man Fest was 2014.
Sandwich making contest.
It was a different time.
That popped up in my fucking Facebook memories the other day, and it reminded me of my kids selling duct tape wallets. And my one kid playing bassoon.
I still have one.
And then my other kid was hustling people at that Hammerschlagen game. For root beers, to the point where Johnny's ran out of root beer to switch to cream soda.
Didn't he play oboe there?
Yeah.
That was my oldest. It was the bassoon.
The bassoon.
That was pre we got any sort of event insurance or anything.
Oh, yeah.
Because now, like, I could imagine.
There was a cop at that one. That was like the first one there was a cop at.
Was it a cop or listener? Was it like, hey, I'm just here. I am a cop if shit goes down. But hey, you know.
Yeah. Because if I would explain to like Blanchard Insurance, like, all right, this is what we're gonna do at our event. We're gonna get a bunch of logs and big fucking nails, and then hand out hammers to everybody. And,
no, not just any hammer, a pointed end hammer,
machine hammer, where the point is. Yeah.
Or you can cut your finger off if you hit it right.
You know, I mean, it's a good zombie killing hammer because it'll definitely sink into your skull and kill you.
That's also good for diaper dogs.
And we're going to get everybody shit-faced. Right. Drunk.
You guys really emphasized the part where you had to buy a beer if you lost. People were getting hammered.
And by the way, the highest guy you've ever met is the judge of this competition.
And then once we get bored of it, we're going to leave the nails and the hammers to the children while we eat hamburgers.
Yeah. And
I think I judged that one pretty good. The first one thing you had me judge at that that fish restaurant up in like Altamont Springs.
Never talk about that fish restaurant.
You guys had me judge the ping pong tournament, and I had no idea what I was doing.
I forgot about the ping pong tournament at the fish restaurant. I literally have no recollection of this.
I feel like I'm in the car chasing Castleberry Flatbed Santa. I have no idea of what. Please, Ross, refresh my memory.
Do you remember it was the
place. It was like kind of where like Kiki's Breakfast Cafe and that vegan place. What's that vegan place up
oh,
there?
Oh, Shipyard.
Oh, shit. Okay. It was
so
Shipyard.
Yeah, yeah. My third touchstone was going to be, remember you couldn't park there? You guys did a thing there and you did a guy had given you an airbrushed ping pong table with your faces on it.
I looked like a Mexican senator and you looked like Frodo.
And it was so shitty that both of you guys passed on it and decided to give away to a listener who was going to win a ping pong tournament at this thing. And I had no idea how to run a ping pong tournament. So I was like, all right, two teams, best of three. This is like best of 3 points. Because there's a million fucking teams. What am I going to do? Watch people play like fucking 3 or 4 games of ping pong to determine who's better? No. Best of 3. And there were a lot of legitimately good ping pong players were pissed off about that decision.
Was that when Tiffany played... her and her guitarist played music.
I don't know. Did we did so many.
That D-Rock
came. That was a different one.
That was Oblivion.
Yeah. Yeah. No, that was Shipyard.
They did it at Shipyard too. Tiffany and an accompanist. Yeah.
Mm. My favorite meeting we ever had is still at that Shipyard. We're talking. I don't care talking shit because they're not around anymore.
Now it's the Rollins College Library.
Yeah. Yeah. It's like a
still can't.
It's like a bookstore. Yeah, it's a bookstore with an Einstein bagel inside of it. But like I remember going there after everything and the manager being like, yeah, you guys bring. A lot of people. You bring too many people.
Never again.
We're uninterested. Like, wait a minute.
The guy's like, if we want back to go, we're like, hey, we'll do it again. I think like 200 people showed up. They're like, too many. We have to get a new grill hood. If we have that many people, the fucking fire marshal, we're going to go, no more. Like, I hate money. I don't want people coming here.
And
get
I was
out
like,
of here.
Get fuck your you. Chew toy, Oreo. We're leaving.
For free. We have to fucking bring 200 people. They're like, no.
That worked out for. Oh, no,
yeah.
I too had a taco freak out this weekend on marijuana.
No, really?
Yeah, where? And I want to see how Ross would have handled this because things started getting worse and worse. I went to
shoot the hostage.
Went to a very I
just
off
the top of my head.
I didn't know what I was going to do. I went with my wife and daughter to a pretty famous taco place here in town, and we went to sit down and we were waiting for our tacos to be delivered to our table. And as we're sitting there, it's me and then Maisie and Andrea, and everything is great.
You got
and
your fire sauce. You're all ready to go.
Yeah, exactly. Actually, Maisie loves Taco Bell. She bought me a shirt, Taco Bell shirt. So we're sitting there, we're waiting, and then I look, and then two... And man, and I'm not at all, it's not their fault. They're just there on a Taco Tuesday. Two mega obese people come into the restaurant, and they sit at the table directly to the right. And I'm like, oh, no. Okay, because I don't want Maisie to say anything, and she will, because she's that kind of kid. Mm. So I go,
Daddy, why are manatees eating tacos?
Yeah, it'll be inappropriate, it'll be bad, and I'm just like, just mind your business and eat your taco. Like I'm like, oh, no.
I've been in this scenario. I know Tommy pointed an old lady right across the in the mall, like, old. I'm like,
yep, and so they start it, right? So it's the two, and I mean really big. They're very big, you know, like 5+. Yeah, at least both of them. And God bless them. Eat your tacos.
Still mobile.
Well, when the gentleman was leaving, and this has nothing to do with the story because it does get worse. He had to take a knee. He fell out of his chair. Oh, like, he was so big.
You got him right on the brink of never being able to leave the house.
Yeah. And then I think he fell, and then I think he tried to like pretend he was like Kaepernicking or something. You know, like, and I'm like, okay. So I'm sitting there. I'm like, okay, it's behind her. I think I can manage this.
What would you pay to watch that guy on rollerblades?
I don't know. I mean, does he know I'm watching? I don't want to hurt his feelings.
Yeah, no, yeah. He's signed a waiver. Yeah. It's all good.
He's a big man and a big wife. And again, God bless him. I just don't want my daughter to say anything.
Yeah, for the awkwardness.
Because you and I, like, we have been, like, switching things where, on Thanksgiving, Tom got no orb. I got all orb. My family was ejected from a golf cart and the wheel fell off and they both landed in Coquina Rock, for Christ's sake. That's a Tom story, not a Dan story. So I wait a little bit, and I think I've got it controlled. You know, we're still waiting for the food. This will tell you where I'm at. I'm busily like saying, "Hey, we need to try some more of these sauces from the hot sauce bar."
Keep her distracted.
Yeah. So then I wait, and then a very very loud family comes in with 6 children that are about Maisie's age, and they come in, and their kids are just off the walls, fucking crazy bananas. And I'm like, oh, God, because it's going to spice her up. And I'm like, oh, no. So they come and sit to the right. Mm. So I'm like, fuck. I've got, you know, like mega obese to the left. I've got crazy, uncontrollable kids to the right, which I know that the energy is going to feed off of each other. And then what happens? Mm. Then through the door, The door opens up. The door opens up, and what's standing right there? Older gentleman, curly Q arms.
No.
Both curly Qs.
Oh, okay.
Like, just
two Qs?
Just hands. He was a double Q scenario. Just hands.
How did the door open?
The world may. It's like that Tootsie Roll. Yes. The world may never. A one, a two, a three. A three. So then through the door comes double hands, like curly Q arms, and I'm like, God damn it. I'm like, what the fuck? Oh,
yeah. You got the orb, man. It has not left you.
And then Maisie turns, and she sees him. And I'm like, oh my God, please no, please no, please no. And he's got, you know, he's like got his drink or whatever, and he's kind of cupping it like directly under his chin, and he goes
he's juggling oddly, and he
sits down. I think everything's gonna be okay. I think everything's gonna be all right. Andrea, that's our food. Okay, they're bringing her food. I'm great. I got distraction. I got food. I got chips. I got salsa. I got queso. I'm good. It's gonna be okay. So they come and they set the food down, and then I mean, couldn't have been timed any better. We're about to eat, and then obviously Maisie looks over at Andrea and goes, "How is he able to drink?" and I'm like, "Oh, God, it's fucking happening!" And he looks over, and then they're having a moment, and then Andrea has to explain to him how everybody's built differently, and that like some people's arms are smaller than others, and you know, like, look, he's fine; he's just having a Taco Tuesday,
and then he comes over and he starts like, because he's used to this, so he starts explaining why his arms are underdeveloped.
I'm glad he didn't do that.
And he's like, look at my webs. And you're like, oh!
I'm spray vomiting everywhere.
I'm trying to eat my megawana. Yeah. And you show me webs.
Could you please not web my megawana?
Why are your webs wet?
Excuse me, sir. I think you've got Jason's mom sauce on your webs. That's a real sauce.
I feel like...
How do you guys handle that? Like, I don't know what the fuck to do.
Yeah, kids get a pass,
I usually
right?
do this. Ross, I'm like, I just do this. I just like, look over here. I do like magic tricks.
Yeah, sure, you do the whisper shush.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Then you explain
I totally let Andrea handle the whole thing. Because I was too high. Yeah. I'd already had a rice grain of concentrate on one of my IB Guard peppermint belly pills. That's what I do now. I have these IB Guard pills that they're supposed to keep me from having diarrhea, and I'll heat up the concentrate and I'll squirt a long line on it. And if
I do a full line,
I do a full line now, and then I throw that down the hatch and
on your IB pills,
on my IB guard. It's just peppermint oil. And then as I was sitting there when all this was happening, is when I was ramping up. All I wanted to do is watch some Sports Center, man.
Soon you'll have a Rambo pee-pee diaper on because there's so many different problems. Shock collar, pee-pee diaper.
Oh, you mean like I'll have one?
Because you'll be at the, you know.
I went to the doctor yesterday and they read my blood results and everything's good.
Yeah.
Well, they did recommend a shock collar.
They did recommend a shock collar, but I just wish that I was better in those types of scenarios where I felt like I knew what to do. Like, I didn't know the proper thing to say, because I would have liked
to have said, go ask him.
Well, no, I would have liked to.
Make the situation worse.
Being serious, I'd love to have educated her and been like, well, like, is the correct thing, and I don't think it is, necessarily. Again, I don't know what I'm doing. Should I have said, well, yeah, he's born that way, he's disabled, but look, look at how great he's doing. He's eating his fucking tacos and watching SportsCenter, and he's doing fine. So that should be a lesson to you. You weren't born disabled, so I don't want to hear your shit. Like, should I have done something like that?
No, you said don't talk about it. Treat it as if he was invisible.
Wow. Just now walk over there and talk loud to him. What happened to your arms? Like, do one of those? Like, I don't know.
All right, based on no other facts, the opposite of what Tom said.
My first instinct is,
if only Casper Santa Claus could have driven by the moment that this man sat down with his, Tijuana, flats tacos or whatever. But
we did that 1 year of homeschool, and like basically any question that came up, anything from like, why does that man have arms like that, to like, how does math work, anything, we'd do like an exhaustive Google search on it, and like research the shit out of it, and that burns that out of them real quick.
Hold on a sec. Yeah, so give them over.
Over-educate the little fuckers. Right.
You're like, you start explaining like the medical condition, and then it's like, this is called. You're like, oh, I'm done with it.
I can see my kids the minute I would say, let's look into it, and their eyes would glaze up.
I like that.
I like this.
You use.
I'm stealing that 100%. But that was. I got some. So I. It's funny that we. I knew we would both have like. We both said came into the show that we would have a weed anxiety. That was mine. Wasn't that bad, but it will take your appetite away. Like when you feel because there's a level of embarrassment there that I just like. I don't feel like having to have a. I don't want to look the guy in the eyes and be like, "Hey, man, I'm sorry. My daughter's talking about your curlicues." You know. And, By the way, I love the whisper song.
My takeaway from both you guys is that medical shit is like approaching or beyond my illegal weed guy. You guys are getting higher than I am on a regular basis.
Look, I don't care. Come get me. I'll give you anything you want.
Now there's dispensaries on every corner, and now like it used to be where people were like low key about it, and now like
low key.
You'll see on strip malls like giant marijuana doctor, gigantic weed sign. Like,
we saw in Deland.
Yeah. And so it used to be like, oh, don't it's for people suffering. And now it's just it's exploded.
We have a lot of a way to go though. I just had friends come back from California. I think I was telling you. Friend of mine gave me 1,000 milligram weed pill.
Whoa!
I was telling my weed guy about it, and he was like, "No, that's dangerous."
Because then when you're taking shit, that is like, is this for like leukemia patients?
Like maybe you and I have. Yeah. Have you tried that?
I haven't yet.
This one came in a bag with Oreo written on it.
Like this is for.
Do not open until Casimiro Santa drives by. No, do not open until Christmas.
Make you feel better when your cancer's already turned black. Like it's bad.
At some point, it does reach. Like though, I got a hold of some, and I could talk about it because I got my card. But I got a hold of some when I first got my card. We weren't working with anybody. You know, we didn't have anybody that we knew, and I went to one of the dispensaries over near where Fair Villa is, and I got those. Are they 50s? They're 50s. Yeah. I got these 50 milligram like pills, and I swear to God, they will make you trip your fucking balls off. Like, it's so much.
They're really. Constantly.
I texted him one night, and I'm like, I'm freaking. I need help. Like, I don't want to tell Andrea. I am literally losing my mind right now. I'm in the closet, and I'm standing in my coats, like surrounded by coats, and I'm just standing there, like hiding because I don't know what to do with myself. It's real pure.
Yeah.
And then 20 minutes later, you're watching Grooves in the Heart on YouTube. You're fucking golden.
I had to go face down in the pillow. And just like and just scream a few times and just try to wish it away a little bit.
Let's do our shot now.
Butler gonna do a look at, he brought the mic over.
Sam can do her 3 shots.
Okay, hold on.
Why do I got so many?
Okay, Butler, here you go. Hold on.
I think that's for you, Bart. If you want it.
Which mic are you on? Right. Okay, I'll put your reverb on. There you go. You're good to go. All right. Oh, hold on. I can't hear you. Are you on blue or yellow?
There's no color to this.
Nope. There you go. I got you. You don't see color. You're not racist.
Arriba, abajo, centro, dentro, rock and roll, nueve, cero, dos, uno, cero.
All right.
What the hell?
There it is.
Cheers.
Cheers to you.
Oh, well. Depth chart.
All right. Should we take a quick break, come back with some voicemails and emails?
I mean, I would say let's keep going, but I didn't get to pee last break.
We have a lot of voicemails piled up. Last chance to get some questions in the show at Tom and Dan.
Was he coming back?
Yeah, that one's getting me. Show at TomandDan.com if you'd like to throw an email. Let me see what we... Oh! This is awesome. For those of you that do like the rock and roll, there's a band called Charger. They put an album out, I want to say like 2 or 3 years ago. They're back. They're like a simple like throwback, kind of a throwback to 80s metal band. They're a 3-piece.
Yeah.
Name of the song is Watch Your Back. Enjoy this. We'll be back with more A Mediocre Time right after this.
You're gambling! stealing again, aren't you?
I promise, I'll get it back. There'll be more than enough for bills next month.
Yeah, I've heard that before. I can't live like this anymore.
And now with an update on how he's doing in his addiction, the creator and founder of Never Not Bet. It's your friend Tom Van.
So I went 2-2 again last week. It's not good. I know it's not. It's basically a tie, and then when you're paying the vig, you're losing. So yeah. I still have a winning record, 28-25.
That's awesome.
But I think I'm going to turn around this week. I've tried to not make stupid mistakes and bet on teams that the public are all on.
Yeah, yeah.
And things that are like professional gamblers are
you
like,
you need to march to your own drum, man.
I know. So
what do you got? What do you got? Give it to me.
So, first off, Cincinnati +8. And now, I don't know if you're going to be able to find 8. I found it yesterday because the line's been betting down. So, I think I saw it at 7.5 this morning.
Who are they playing?
They are playing the Browns. And Cleveland is a mess right now. They're basically statistically out of the playoffs. There's a bunch of rumors that Odell Beckham wants to be traded.
Yeah, what did you hear what they said? They were like, what's the future hold? He's like, I don't know the future. It could be anything, Crystal. You know, he's like, I don't know where I'm going.
It's they're the most undisciplined team in the NFL. This is a division rival. I like Cincinnati in the points.
Okay.
So I'm taking Cincinnati +8 against the Browns. Next up, I'm taking Washington +13 against Green Bay.
Okay.
This is all situational. By the way, I'm getting this from professionals here, so it's not coming from me. But apparently,
what's the line?
The line is 13. Washington +13. They're playing Green Bay.
Oof.
And the whole, I guess, point of this bet is a lot of the pros believe Green Bay's looking ahead to next week to the Bears, yeah. The division rival against Chicago. So
Bears didn't look too bad last night.
What the thought is they're going to come out flat against Washington. This is going to be a run-heavy game. Washington's run game has significantly got better.
Yeah, Green Bay already in the playoffs.
Yeah, Green Bay is probably just going to come out with a win on this game, 13 points. Is a lot. I'm taking Washington +13.
Okay.
Next up, this is a total that I'm betting Ravens versus the Bills. I'm going over 44 points.
This is a must-watch game for a lot of people. A lot of people want to see if this is a great test for the Bills.
Yes, and apparently the matchup, I've listened to some handicap guys.
Don't ever listen to a handicap guy. They don't know what they're talking about.
They're handicapping the game.
No, I'm kidding.
They're
being a terrible person.
They're handicapping the game, and apparently the matchup is...
Listen to some handicapped guys.
It's really... why'd I phrase it like that? God damn it.
You know what? That's the best thing. Can I hug you right now? That's the funniest thing you've ever said. I listen to some handicapped guys.
I meant to say handicappers, which is...
Never call them
my stepdad.
You can't call them that.
Oh, no.
God damn. I've been waiting in line. This self-checkout, this handicapper over here can't even scan his app.
The professionals that look to see... which team?
Scan your apples, handicapper!
Anyway, they think that the Ravens match up really good against the Bills, and this is going to be a higher scoring game.
Okay.
And they think the Bills can score against the Ravens.
Do you have a teaser?
Yeah, I do have a teaser.
Oh, you love a good teaser, don't you?
So again, Bills Ravens over 44. And this teaser is interesting because this week a lot of good teams are playing a lot of good teams.
Yeah.
So
it's kind of like, you know, for those of us that really love football, I mean, like, did you throw that 49ers game in there?
Yes, I did.
That's a good game.
So
That's my must-watch game. Yeah.
Speaking of that, San Fran...
Sorry, did I fuck you up?
No. San Fran is +2 at New Orleans, so they are actually the underdog playing in New Orleans.
I cannot believe that.
Well, a lot of the reason is they think that the travel, like they played Baltimore, they lost, and then they...
Well, I was going to say...
But they stayed there.
Did Baltimore expose, like, what their... Like, is that what changed
the line? Not really, because
a
lot of people are talking about how San Francisco played really well. And it comes comes down to a field goal, right. You know, and they did lose.
It was a hell of a match.
But they stayed on the East Coast, which a lot of people don't know, so they didn't travel back to San Francisco and then back again.
Okay.
They stayed from last week's game, and they practiced on the East Coast so that they wouldn't have all that travel.
That's a good thing.
And apparently, a lot of teams have been doing this so that the team's camaraderie, they're together, they're practicing in the same space, they don't have any distractions.
Just rest.
Yeah.
Got some rest.
So I'm teasing San Francisco, Kansas City against New England. Kansas City is plus three.
So many good games this week.
So Kansas City is getting 3 points.
Kansas City plus three?
Plus three.
Over Brady and team.
And Rams are even against Seattle, right? So because they're playing at home.
I disagree with that.
So all good teams are getting points. Now,
who are you taking on that Seattle game?
Well,
I would take Seattle.
No. Well, this is what I'm doing. I'm teasing plus seven all three of these games. So I'm teasing San Francisco up to 9, Kansas City up to 10, and the Rams up to 7. So San Fran plus 9, Kansas City plus 10, and the Rams plus seven. I'm getting all these points with these good teams, and even if they lose, I think they'll keep it close. These are all three really good teams.
Correct.
So that's a 7-point teaser, and as long for my beer bet, I'm going to go with Atlanta minus 3 against Carolina. This is the market on Magnolia
You're going with your theory that with teams whose coaches have just been blown out have something to prove and they're going to dance on Atlanta. Is that what you're guessing?
Yes. Hopefully, the problem
is... I hope not, because fuck Carolina, you know, but, you know, Atlanta sucks. My team.
I want you guys to win a free Cigar City beer, but...
I do, too.
Selfishly, I also want to be right, and there's a lot of people that think the line actually... And normally, when you lose a coach, the team is better because they're like, oh, this coach is bringing.
By the way, I disagree with blowing that coach out.
Well, everybody loved old Ron Rivera.
Was he not performing?
Well, he's just old school, and the new ownership wanted to go more analytical.
I get it, but is your team not performing?
Well, they weren't.
So they're going to blow him out, but they're not going to blow out my guy, old Dan Quinn? Whether you want a hoagie, handmade hoagie, chopped salads, a wood-fired pizza, or a poke bowl, they got it all covered, plus 40 TVs, full liquor bar, and all the beer you can drink.
Absolutely. So if you're watching the game and I lose this, Atlanta minus 3, you can get a free beer. Again, Cincinnati plus 8, Washington plus 13, Ravens and Bills over 44, and a 7-point teaser, San Fran, Kansas City, and Rams. Good luck out there, and continue gambling.
Oh, is it freaking out?
It is.
Oh, wow. Hold on. I'll go back and see if it won't freak out. Let's see if it won't freak out. There we go. You know, I didn't know until I heard that cover that it was that song by Foster the People. I think that's who originally did
correct.
That. I had no idea that song was You Better Run Faster Than My Bullet. Like, is it, I'm really? Gonna steal your shoes? Is that what that is?
I think that was the, yeah.
Like the pumped up kicks? Like I'm gonna...
Like, you better run faster than my bullet.
What she's saying. Yeah. She's like, you better run faster than my bullet.
I thought it was this cool shooting thing. I thought that's what they were doing when it came out.
No idea.
It might just be me.
Well, it's a great, that's a great cover of Pumped Up. Welcome back to a Mediocre Time with Tom and Dan. I am Dan.
I'm Tom. God.
Samantha's here. Our good friend Ross McCoy is here. Bart Merrick's here. Butler's here. Gester here.
Back in the 90s, I would have killed for some fucking Reebok pumps.
Hell yeah.
You know, they're back.
I know, but I don't care now.
They're very expensive now, too, because like they've actually made the technology like better.
Oh, so, these are the ones that like actually will form and...
Well, but they're for like CrossFit folks, and they make like an all-purpose like gym shoe that you can just like... I don't think there's laces. You just pump it, but it's not
that far even, huh?
Yeah, it's pretty sweet.
Because back in the day, it was just like filling in the cracks. There's like an air sac, and make sure the shoe can form fully to your foot.
This is a pretty legit... Like, Reebok's come along. I'm kind of a Reebokman. I'm about to go buy me some Reeboks. Seth got me on Reeboks.
Ah.
I don't like the new Reebok logo.
I like the throwback ones. I don't like the new logo. I like the classics.
Yeah.
So, Ross, I wanted to ask you this because I like asking you parenting advice. Right.
You need to learn how to shoot and build. When somebody attacks you, you need to build up. You get out of there.
Man, the building, was this a Fortnite question? Building is the hardest
part. It is the hardest part. It's the only difference.
Not question, but hardest part. Like,
and I can never decide if I would like it better with or without it. I don't know. Because that's what I'm bad at, but I don't know. Maybe it'd be different.
I love the look of the game, and I think it looks so fun, but I am not good, man.
I'm like Pop-Pop sitting here. I'm like, what are they talking about?
We're talking about the war, Pop-Pop. No, like we're talking about Fortnite.
Video poker.
Oh. I'm really bad at Fortnite, but it's the style of animation though as games that I love.
When's the last time you checked in? Because now they do skill based matchmaking, so you will be put in a lobby with people as bad as you are.
Okay, then I'll get back in. I didn't know that they had like kind of leveled things out because when I get in there, I'm dusted. Yeah. Like people just go like, fuck you, dickhead.
That's
You're
all
out.
Different. I win once in a while now. So
nice.
Do you play on Twitch?
No, I should.
You should.
I should look into that.
Tots with Ross.
Yeah.
And then Fortnite on Twitch.
Ross has a podcast called The Orlando Talk Show with Ross McCoy that you can check out. Subscribe, please, like, listen. But yeah, I would watch that.
So this my guy, my
he's,
question.
He's not allowed to play video games.
I'm allowed to, I guess. Well, you know, you're right. what am I going to lie to you at this point? You know.
Maybe if you get yourself an Oreo, your wife will be preoccupied. You can play some video games.
You know what? She was like very happy that she had, you know, I think that's a thing, a psychological thing where like, because now there's no more babies.
And she wants a baby.
And I'm like,
I want a baby.
No more diapers in the house.
And Andrea doesn't want a baby because she pushed it out and had 3 months, you know, 3+, almost 4 months of colic. I want a baby. I would take another baby.
My wife definitely would take one for sure, but when that dog was at her house for a couple hours, she was preoccupied with the dog and super happy, so maybe it's something to be said with getting a dog so she could be like,
Or perhaps six dogs.
All the stuff starts coming, and the poo-poo out of the toilet.
Then you're living in just poo-poo and Amazon packages everywhere.
Then the hazmat people come because Daniel...
And then E.T.'s there. He's turned white because he's...
And then I'm smoking in front of the hazmat people as they clean my garbage. And they're like, how do you live like this? And they're like, we just become
complacent. Don't throw that out. That bag of peas. Don't throw out that bag of peas. It's just a little puffy.
Going back to Castleberry Santa, when
nobody ever goes back to Castleberry Santa.
My son Tommy, the oldest one, did say, like, well, that's not real Santa, right? And then we didn't know what to say because, like, we're like, Santa. And then because
I just feel like I just pretend to be asleep.
His briefcase is gonna work.
Yeah, I got break.
His immediate response was like, what? Like, he questioned it. He's like, well, Santa, why? Why is real Santa riding on the back of a flatbed with the Castleberry police?
Well, times are tough for like, Santa.
Can he fly? Yeah. All the shit you've been telling me? Wait a minute.
He's building his career back like Louis C.K. He's starting with the flatbed. And he's going to work his way back up into the arenas. I mean, he had it all, but he just flashed his penis a couple times. It's all gone now.
To a couple elves that were underneath him, and it was like a job thing.
It was like a power thing. Yeah, he's like, you know, if you really want to not make wooden horses anymore, I can get you up to making the electronics if you'll watch me jack off into the cereal box.
He didn't block the door, but he stood in front of it while he was jacking off, so it was kind of blocked.
I mean, you could have gotten out, but could you have gotten out? You know, like, who knows?
He did announce, I'm going to start jacking off, and they didn't leave, so it's kind of on them.
It's on him.
Anyway, so...
Hard to jack off in a flatbed trailer for only the very hard.
So, what should my response have been, Ross? Because me and my wife just kept, like, she was driving, I just stayed there in the high freaking
Turn up the music.
I didn't know to say, like,
it's a holiday.
Because I figured by saying no, then I have to go through the explanation about who that is and why is he doing this. And then
why are we following him?
Then if I said yes, then I feel like then he's going to be thinking, why is he doing this on the back of a flatbed? Right. Why is he
flying? None of it makes any sense.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
We just lie to our children.
I know. And to Ross, years ago, told me that he didn't do any of this.
That's
bullshit.
Why it's hard for me, because my decision tree and yours branch so far back.
I should have gone with the goddamn Ross.
My kids would have been like, oh, yeah, look at that homeless old man on the flatbed. This was a fun lark. Let's go back and watch some more Simpsons on Disney Plus. But for you, what I would recommend is saying, no, of course, Santa's at the North Pole making your wooden toys or whatever the fuck he does.
They don't want anything wood. They're wood? Fuck your wood.
Presumably banging a plump, rosy-cheeked woman every night, and he sends a helper to spread Christmas joy throughout the land, and there are many such helpers throughout the land riding flatbeds or perhaps hay bales down south.
And all of them smoke cigarettes. Every single one.
Yeah, see, that's good. I couldn't come up with anything. I just stayed silent. And
oh, no, you got to do it like Charles Dickens style. And they all smoke cigarettes. Every single one.
I just have a feeling that this day and age seems harder to keep it going.
It's got
to
be, right?
Right? Yeah. Like
in the 80s. I don't think I have much time.
There was kids still in their fucking like 11, 12 years old that still believe.
No, I honestly don't believe I have much time.
Yeah, because it seems like
I'll be dead very soon.
There's too
much. What are we talking about?
Information. Like kids are exposed to too much.
Will Santa become a thing of the past? Because of knowledge and technology.
Who's working for BuzzFeed now?
You're in Jackie's good question group. That's a great fucking question, dude.
Well, I think it will.
Because kids are going to get, as they're finding out younger and younger, at what point is it even
as traditions
a thing,
change,
right?
As religion change? That's a good question,
Sam. I think the ability to keep it up for long periods of time is going to be diminished for sure. Because, like, with all
Did
this,
you guys get Extends as a sponsor?
it's almost impossible. And because these kids are, I think, is better educated, more logical. You know, like, there's less folklore and everything. You know what I'm saying?
I mean, we would have had to go to the library and look up a book and like be like, is that book right? I don't know. Now you just go to a fucking any tablet. Your TV. You go to your TV. TV. Search, is Santa real for me?
Tell me if you feel this way. There is less magic in, like, the experience I'm having with my daughter at Christmas than I thought was there, because I only based it on the magic that I felt like I had with my parents
who are
fucking idiots. Like, do you know what I mean? Like, it's like, I don't, like, the what they sell you, you know, or what you think you're going to have when you have a child, and the reality of, like, dialing in the holidays is completely different. It is not, like, Maisie's, I said it during the break, I was telling Russ, she looks at her elf on the shelf, and she's like, you know, I did a prank where the elf drew on bananas, and Maisie was like, this is a doll. To Andrea. And like, and Ross referenced it. I just grabbed my messenger bag and I'm like, fucking, I'm out. I'm not doing it.
I'm leaving the family. I'm gonna go out and get a pack of cigarettes. I'll see you later.
Remember the morning you came in super early?
Yeah.
Super early, and I was already here super early. It was a get the fuck out of here scenario.
Well, that brings up a good point too, because Ross, you never did any elf on the shelf bullshit. The anti-elf on the shelf should just be Ross's face.
He did bong on the lawn. That's a whole different.
Because now,
actually, that's Buddy Dyer's son.
It's just called Ross telling the truth. It doesn't rhyme. Fuck you.
Because now, you know, this could be part of the problem. Because now, all these parents,
we are part of the problem. We lied. We fucking lied, and we're gonna get burned for it.
Now there's, from December 1st to the 25th. Now there's 25 days of bullshit that we got to come up with every morning.
You know what's better than that? No kids. No kids. So, don't have to worry about lying to anybody. So, don't have to keep this shit up for years.
So
she's right.
Think about it. In the 80s, or even before, you know, in the past, before this fucking elf on the shelf bullshit, you had one night not to fuck it up. Like, don't get too drunk. You got to put together the presents. You got to tiptoe around
it's
the house. And like, you got one night.
Remember to leave out the milk and cookies and then pretend to eat it and leave crumbs and a fucking empty milk glass on the goddamn table. And a chewed down little carrot, because Rudolph needs a carrot too.
But there was only.
Do you think I want to drink milk after 12 Bud
Lights? Fuck no!
It's disgusting.
With a carrot? Fuck you!
Like, this is garbage. I mean, Bud Light, not good, but milk on Bud Light, really bad.
So we only had one night of bullshit to do and like not fuck it up and like make sure the kids don't see you, whatever. Yeah. Now there's 25 nights because the people are wrapping their goddamn kitchens and Christmas paper because they're like, look what the elf did. And then like the kids are ripping it down. They're like, whoa, you spent the whole night doing that shit. They're like, what's next? Fucking one more night.
Give me more, you piece of shit.
And then
just go back to the advent calendar. Call it a fucking day.
We have two.
You can't go back.
We have two. We have
should've never started.
We have a we have a Barbie accessory advent calendar, and then we have a Disney book. The you know what? She likes the book one better, which I'm like, oh god.
So you get a new book every
day. Small victory. Small victory.
I like the Lego ones. Those are fun.
They're so hard to find now.
Yes, you got to get them early.
Very coveted. But Andrea found this Disney book collection one that's dope because you open it up and it's like tiny books. The only problem is I need my glasses to read because they're full fucking books. It's like Dumbo, the entire story. You know? I'm like, oh god.
Is it like the golden books from back in the day? Because Disney golden books
very
were sick.
Much, but they're only about like 4 inches high, 4 inches wide, but the print, it's a full fucking novel. It's like, you want to hear about Incredibles 2? Where I'm going to start at the beginning, I'm going to take you through a 2-hour fucking movie. Mm-hmm. It's too much.
Ross will love this. So we, this year.
This is a new segment called We Confess Everything that Ross knew was going to happen to Ross, and then he laughed.
He's laughing, laughing.
Yeah, laugh, laugh.
So in the past, we started doing Elf on the Shelf because we're bullied into it by society. And my wife's like, everybody's doing it, we have to do it.
I thought you had two elves.
We do.
Isn't this everything you're supposed to teach your children not to do? Cave into
peer pressure? Yeah.
Okay. Well, we're peer pressure.
I'm just making notes here.
I started doing cocaine, like only because of this goddamn elf, because I was peer pressured.
You gotta stay up and figure something out.
You're talking to a Ricky Gervais-level atheist who sends his kid to Christian school.
Yeah,
I know. In my wife's eyes, if we don't do Elf on the Shelf like other people, then my sons are going to find out, and it's just as bad as Adrian Peterson whipping your legs. Like it's the same thing. Like, wow. Adrian Peterson whipping your legs and not doing Elf on the Shelf is the same fucking thing.
I see it. I see your logic.
So anyway, so we started doing it, but we started doing it with our own elves that the kids got.
Handmade.
Not handmade, but they got these elves.
No, Handmaid's Tale is what I meant.
Oh, I'm saying there were hands on my hips.
Tom's really trying to knock up this elf.
So we got these, like, they're not the standard Elf on the Shelf, like the corporate.
They're very Castleberry.
They're the Castleberry ones that the kids got at their VPK. Like, they each got one with their little name on it.
It's always hiding on the Hess flatbed truck.
So, the Hess truck is here. The Hess truck's here.
So this year, Crystal comes to me and she's like, they have different elves than all the other kids, and they're going to find out once they, like, Tommy's going to talk to the other kids in the class. They all have the same standards.
What's your elf look like? Hey, what's your elf look like? Well, my elf is Puerto Rican, has earrings. Hoops.
Yeah. So, but they're all.
My elf will set your shit straight. But my elf can't cash her Amscot check. She's going to fuck you up.
But the elf is the standard corporate Elf on the Shelf.
Yeah, that's what I have. Yeah.
Like, it all looks the same.
Yeah, it's long. It's a tall.
But are they going to other kids' houses? Like,
no,
they're not going to know.
I know. That's what I. Anyway, but I've, in an effort not to argue with my wife or to be just cool and.
See, things have changed.
To be left alone while I gamble. I'm just like, yeah, whatever they get, you know, buy the whatever. And so my wife buys two of the corporate Elf on the Shelves.
Dude, those are expensive as fuck.
You should have done, instead of Elf on the Shelf, you should have used the French witch and put her in different scenarios every day.
And then put her on top of your wife sleeping, witch and a bitch.
Or start doing it for Halloween.
You know what? Thank you, sir. I fist bump.
What? You did a fist bump?
Bones.
He's never done bones. And bones, give me bones.
Witch on a bitch made me give you bones. Now I regret the second.
You know,
one,
I did too. The second one. You know what?
We'll cut that out.
I'll punish myself.
So they were used to the two, like, Bobo elves.
There were many.
Yeah, they were like green. They basically stuffed animals that they were elves, but they weren't nothing like the corporate Elf on the Shelf that everybody has. So anyway, so my wife's like, we got to tell the boys that,
those elves died.
That they were the training elves. Look at the web of lies.
It's training.
My God, it is too much.
Wait,
guys.
Like Subway, they're the purple shirt elves, and then the green shirt elves come in. Those are the real sandwich artists. The purple ones were just trying to, like, they were homeless. They thought they could get a job. They couldn't really. We caught them smoking crack behind the subway.
No, that was Oreo's real family. Two birds with one stone, dude. Get rid of everything.
See, you needed to call the pros.
I know.
You needed to call Ross.
So I'm sitting there, and she's telling me this as if, like, we had just robbed something, and she's getting my alibi straight for the cops, because I'm going to be interrogated
right,
one day.
The kids are shining light in your face. What are you going to say, Tom? What are you going to say?
And she's like, all right, so get this straight. So the old elves, they were the training elves, and now they've graduated to these new elves, and the old elves flew back to Santa.
They went to another farm. We got the nanny. I can't remember what's going on with that, but they're with the nanny now.
They're living the rest of their days in pasture.
They've been released in happy elf pasture.
And then she's like, and the new elves, those are the real ones. They're going to be. And then she's like, I got a male and a female.
No, so never get both. Now you're going to have babies. Because the male elf, he's going to be jacking it into one of your plants, and the girl elf's complaining because guys are pieces of shit.
Family of elves, backstory. You're like, which one's little Billy?
He's like, I'm in charge, and this elf wants to be as good as I am, but so I made her watch me jack off into your toaster, because that's what elves do.
All I can ever think about is how my pop-up is laughing at me. Like, you dumb motherfucker, look what you did to yourself. Like,
and the beauty of that is he's not. That's not real.
So I'm like, okay. So then the day finally came where the new elves showed up.
What are their names?
Well, the problem was the old ones are just
named their names.
They're just Max and Tommy. Which one? So okay,
some egotistical shit when you got an elf named.
It's like little voodoo dolls of his own children.
Yeah. So then
I got Dodie. Dodie the elf. She's Spanish. She has earrings.
So my wife gets the fucking book and all that. And by the way, in my mind, I'm against all this shit because I'm like, we already have the elves. Whatever. It's already done. Yeah. Like, who gives
They're named
what?
After the kids.
Why the new ones? But my wife is concerned that Tommy's going to feel left out if he tells or, like, he sees other kids and their elves. And they're
elves they don't bring their elves to school. So there's
you can't touch them.
Well, that's what I'm saying. He's never going to see the other kids' elves.
No, you're not allowed to touch them or you'll knock their magic off. So you have to use, like, barbecue tongs.
Samantha, nowadays.
Move them around the house.
Nowadays, with the easy instant pictures and shit,
they're going to see their friends on TikTok.
On Facebook, they're 4 and 5.
No, but they bring TikTok. All the projects now have pictures associated with them because it's.
But that's easy. You just say our elves are special. They got those dumb elves that everybody else has. We got the cool special elves named Max and Tommy, by the way.
Yeah, our elves are special. They have just hands, no arms. They're drinking a soda at Tijuana Flats and fucking everything up.
She was afraid that. They're being bullied. They got the Bobo elves, good quality $30 ones or whatever the fuck.
They're not good quality, trust me.
Anyway.
Where did you get these initial elves, though? I guess that needs to be. Were these dollar store elves?
No, free from school.
Oh, even worse.
Every kid from his school has that elf anyway.
And VBK, no, but the problem is, I think the other parents.
They were like, these aren't real elves. We need to buy the $30 elves.
Yeah, they went the elf on the shelf. I went cheapo. I'm like, hey, we got free elves.
Put
the
elf.
Anyway, you got free lunch. Lunch the elf.
Lunch the elf.
Yeah, there's elf on a shelf and elf on welfare. That's what you got.
Tommy's got the, hide his elf food stamps on his boots.
Elf on the dole.
So, anyway.
elf on reduced lunch is, I think, what that's called.
So, then the day comes where the new elves show up, and then
and they're like, "What's up? We're the new elves. You're so cool."
So we put my wife puts them in the tree. The whole thing's like, remember, the new elves came. The training elves went back to the Santa Claus with the lists and all the shit.
Just slaps your face. Don't fuck this up.
And you're like, "All right, new elves, old elves, live.
Waterboarding elves.
It's totally fine. Like, just give me more marijuana."
So
now we all know how you open the show is super important. What are the new elves doing the first day? What are they doing?
No, they started off in the tree. Like, their first day in the tree.
Failure.
Where the
failure.
Yeah, that's
no bit the first day. Get the fuck not new elves. I want the old elves back.
That's bold. They should have started out doing something. Yeah. The tree is
How
like
about anything.
I mean, the tree is like Everest, right?
So
I mean,
hack.
If you're in the tree, no, but also it's like the pinnacle. If you're in there, it's like you've completed Christmas.
So I guess they start. I don't know what the fuck. Anyway, so the boys wake up and they're like the elves, and then my wife's like, I think the elves are. So the boys jump out of bed.
Oh, you have to tell them that? I don't have to tell me.
That's what I'm saying. His kids.
Well, they have no recollection.
Their meter does not move because they're just like Tom. So they probably don't even give a fuck.
When
about
Maisie, care as about soon them. As Maisie, if Maisie's sleeping, it's a. What's Dodie doing? And I'm like, fuck! That's I didn't move her! I'm like, go check on your mom. Go check on your mom. I run downstairs. Like, well, now, you know, that's, she is like.
They're like that now, but this was the first time. So they didn't know it was December. Like, they had no concept of it's supposed to be here. Anyway, so they run. They're like, oh, excited. They run over to the tree, look up at the, you know, the
new elves.
The new ones that are like everybody else's.
The non-training elf.
The regular elf on the shelf, the corporate bullshit that corporate everybody has bullshit, or whatever.
Correct.
They looked at it, and they're like, where's the other one sitting?
Boys, I'm so sorry to tell you.
And then my wife's like devastated, and then I start going into the goddamn alibi. I'm like, the other one's left to go to Santa. I'm fucking it all up.
You're doing the spiel. I'm like, the other one's left to go to Santa. Santa's getting a divorce. And the one of us is attorney. The other one's his best friend. The best friend's taking him out for a steak dinner at Del Frisco's. The other one's trying to work it through so he doesn't lose his fucking condo.
So then my wife's like, well, then these are the. And then she starts trying to sell it on him like she's a goddamn vacuum cleaner. She's like, these are the real good. These are the non training elves. These are the ones that everybody else has.
That's a mishandle.
And look at the book. The book says, and she's like reading on the book, but I can tell in their eyes they're disappointed.
Sad. They were attached.
Because they were used to the old goddamn one.
And that's what they want to talk about, not these new fucking interlopers.
Yeah, so then we're like.
So you need to show them the crime scene photos of those elves being stabbed in the.
Oh, yeah. Like the police, like when you try to kill your husband.
And then you tell them that one of the elves that is the new elf is one of the suspects. And you're like, we haven't sorted it out yet.
It gets better.
And
so,
then you shut the door, and then you go jack off in a plant to escape what's happening. Let your wife handle it.
So then, you know, we went through the whole spiel, and they're like, these are new ones. Blah. We could tell they were kind of disappointed. They went on with their day. And then the whole day, my wife's texting me, I made a mistake. I'm an idiot. Like, she's be like,
Why didn't you be like, you did? an idiot.
No, I told you that the old ones were fine.
No, that's not my style.
You're wrong.
No, I can't.
I win. Old elf. No. Double blow job.
No.
Another girl, except I want to dress like an elf.
I'm just quietly reviewing my lines for an NFL football. And she's like, I made a mistake, whatever, we have to fix this. And then I'm like, well, how are we going to fix it?
You
she's
can't.
Like,
no, now you've
old elves back. We're double. I was like, it's goddamn making him. It's like making a murderer now. I'm like, what's the story? She's like, now the new elves.
Came back. The new elves, they weren't well received. They decided they'd move on and bring in the some familiar faces. Ladies and gentlemen, Max and Tommy the Elf.
You just need an official letter on elf headquarter letterhead.
I can
recalling
that
the previous elves. Sorry we made a mistake. Yeah. Your old elves are back. The new elves are undergoing some training.
No.
Thank you for using Elfco elves.
The newer elves that we implemented are specialists. They're trained killers and we need them on the front lines. They've been called up. We're fighting a war on Christmas.
I don't know. They had herpes. They
gotta come. Okay, I like that.
So the next night, I'm watching my wife.
Dude, your life is a nightmare.
I know! I've been telling you!
It's a nightmare.
So
Ross, nothing has changed.
She takes the $35 elves or whatever the fuck back. She's like, all right, we're gonna hide these in the closet.
No, take them back!
Yeah, they're not gonna use them.
$35 fucking dollars!
Oh, they've already got shit on them.
Shit!
What? Because Oreo shit all over.
And now then the next day, the training elves are back. And
you
then,
waste yeah. so
but they're
much
wearing
money.
Diapers and shot collars for some reason.
And it's this whole elaborate lie. The kids are happy again. And these corporate
we're
elves.
We're back, everybody. We got rid of the other elves and we're back. Kids Max and Tommy.
I start explaining this elaborate story. They're just like, elf. And they're like, they don't give two fucks.
Yeah, they don't.
Where's my Cheerios, Daddy?
Yeah. I'm like, why are we doing
doing this? What are we doing?
So you're still using the Bobo elves?
Yeah, back to Bobo.
Good. That just makes me a little bit better than you.
Back to Bobo.
When you got the other elves, I was like, you're on my level. But now I still can bully you a little bit about having those Bobo elves.
Why? This is ridiculous. If you, any 1950s dad and Ross is always laughing at us.
Yeah, we're down to the level now where, like, we just ask them what they want. It's Christmas time. What do you want? Okay, we ordered it on Amazon. Happy, Merry Christmas.
It's fine. They love it.
They love it. The box comes.
That's all I care
they
about.
Fucking want them. Oh, my monitor. Oh, my mouse. Oh, my new phone.
Yeah. If whatever, like, if I get a present, I'm not asking where. I'm happy about the present. That's all.
Exactly.
Like, how did it get here? You bought it, Santa? Mm-hmm. Who gives a fuck? And now it's here.
I don't even want the present. Like, they give me the present. I'm like, I'm too tired to open it. You open it, or you take it. If it's good, keep it, or give it to me. If it's like, okay, you keep it.
It's a new briefcase, Daddy.
So I can run away faster. You want to do some voicemails?
Yeah, let's do some voicemails.
I have a feeling Ross might like this one. Let's see.
Hey, Tom and Dan, and everyone else. I was listening to last week's Friday Free Show, and you guys were talking about... older people getting circumcised. And,
I knew dick problem.
Great grandfather.
Dick problem. Every voicemail.
Rest in peace. He was actually circumcised around age 80. I guess he just kind of stopped washing in there because of his old age, and got infected. So they had to cut the old thing off. All right. God bless. Bye.
God bless.
80. God damn.
Because he said, my dick stinks? Fuck it. I'm not washing it ever again.
You got 80 years and then they cut your dicks get off.
No, dude. Because he stopped cleaning it.
The older you get, the more shit you give up on.
It's true.
But I've never heard of that, though. Like, that it got so infected they had to cut the skin off? Can't they just give you some antibiotics?
No.
Not at 80. At 80, probably it was easier. Because you know how it is. Like, a cut you would have had when you were 12 that would have healed the next day. Takes like for you like 3 days now, for me a month and a half.
I can only imagine it's like cutting a mummy's wrappings. Like, it's like, is it gonna disintegrate like in my hands? Like, what?
Just take the whole thing.
Yeah.
You don't need it anymore. He can pee out of his butt.
I mean,
like I do.
That's how I used to think girls did it.
Ideally, we'll get to the point, and I think we're close. We're like, I got a wart on my foot. Take the whole leg. Give me a robot leg.
Just
tie the robot leg right into me.
Which goes right into my next thing. Have you guys seen the new emojis that are for like handicapped
people? Are they cyborg emojis?
Yeah, like check this out. And I'm not saying it's bad, but it's kind of scary.
It's like three black Santas with a cyborg guy?
No. You'll like this. Here, I'll text you one. I'll text you one right now because... hold on. I got one. I'll text you both the new
ones. Come on, Dan. That's a picture of your
dick.
Okay,
one of them is a robot leg, and the other one is a robot arm.
Oh, yeah. Like a Cable from the X-Men.
Yeah, so like I think it's totally cool. And trust me, I'm not, you know, if I were a kid and I didn't have an arm or I had a prosthetic, I would want an emoji for me.
Yeah.
But like I was like, are these like really like for handicapped people or is this the beginning? Like
robots making
I had a conversation with Tom and I was like, look, man, you might think this I'm trying to like work on a bit or something. I'm like, no, it's weird that these like robot arms and legs have popped up as emojis because like I can't imagine that there are enough people with prosthetics to need having an athletic robot leg in a like a what looks to be like a Nike running shoe. Is that like a thing?
Let me ask you, did he start this question with what is the deal with robot
legs? I did.
This is a new stand-up bit.
Robot legs in cars having coffee.
it's got to be Apple just wanting to be more PC and they're just like, hey, let's add everything we can so no one bitches.
Yeah, sure. It's robots sneaking in their own emojis, man. I'm telling you right now.
I go back and forth on robots. Like, I'd see like my Roomba and it systematically eliminates every square inch of dirt. And then, like,
your fan?
Fucking Pandora can't play soul coughing in the soul coughing station. So, like, which one are we going to get trying to kill us?
What do you think
know.
Of the Roomba? Are you a fan?
I did like it a lot. At a certain point, we just got, like, it's hard to, like, track it down. We just lost track of it one day. It was under somebody's bed.
Yeah.
It got lost. Yeah. And we kind of lost the Roomba.
Ours eats a lot of Barbie shoes. and that'll fuck a room up bad. Like a Barbie high heel, and the next thing you know, it's like flipped over and looks like a car crash. There's like smoke coming out of it.
This is something you can try in the world, whether or not you have a Roomba. Go out into the world and talk to people about Roombas. 75% of the time, somebody will bring up the fact that a Roomba will roll over dog shit and track it over your house. All the time.
It'll get caught up in the gears, or we talked about it on the show.
It'll spray it. It'll whack it crazy.
The guy delivering my Roomba brought that up. Like, it comes up every time you bring up a fucking Roomba. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Any sort of dog shit, especially wet dog shit, it'll just get in the gears and just... And then it's done. And then you can never get it out.
And then all I do is put a Santa hat on it, put it in the tree. It's my new elf on the shelf. It's like the shit Roomba. You want to do some more voicemails?
Let's try. We'll say voicemail brought to you by Precision Door, 407-710-BDMS. Call up Big Tim and get that silent package for Christmas. It's a good gift that keeps on giving because you'll have an awesome-ass garage door that you can control with your phone that's quiet as hell.
This Big Tim is... has to weaponize a pressurized spring by now. 100%, right?
Hi, baby.
This is my brand-new Clip of the Week segment. Here we go. I think you'll like this.
So my friend texted me and informed me that her fiance sits on the toilet, eyes closed, door open, right next to the kitchen, and jerks off using his imagination. Well, apparently he had a bit of a miscalculation with his deposit, and she stepped in it and slipped and spilled their beefaroni. Sucking fat titties.
No way that. No one sits with their eyes closed and the door open, jacking off. No one does that.
I feel like if anybody did that, it would be
you. I mean, that's the real question.
Near the kitchen. They did say near the kitchen.
I feel like that. If anybody did that, it would be you.
No, that's absurd. Then he was able to. They got jizz so far into the kitchen.
No. He fell on the floor. Maybe he didn't see it. He got up, thought he had been, done.
But he's saying that she then slipped on it with beefaroni. She was like,
somebody
why would you
jacked off in the hallway? And she slipped with beef. No, I don't know.
The guy thought he was funny.
I like Dan as the one man in the room of 12 angry men defending the possibility of slipping on jack off with your beef.
I can see it happening. Yeah. I can see it happening.
Yeah. Who sits with their eyes closed? Like, hold on. I've had a lot of experience with this subject, and never have I closed eyes.
Like straight, blood on.
We know he's silent, fucks. In right? The silent package in the bedroom with Tom.
Yeah.
So maybe he jacks off eyes wide open.
I'll contend that nobody goes to the bathroom, sits on the toilet, and jacks off with their eyes closed. Okay. They have their eyes open.
That can't be true.
It's not true.
If you go to Urban Dictionary right now, there's a term called spank bank, which means that men store images and ideas and past experiences in their mind and sometimes revisit them and perhaps masturbate to ejaculation onto a floor, and then their girlfriend slips on beefaroni. Your Honor!
I can use my imagination without my eyes being closed. What is everybody?
Can you, Tom?
Can you? I don't know.
Hold on.
Question that statement at the point where it ends at I could use my imagination.
I'm just saying, it's like, do people have to bring up like
it's easier, you know, like
sexual fantasies with the eyes about
or it, like, you get burned out and sometimes you just go back to the well, you know, you refresh everything.
I understand using your past experiences or imagination, but the fact that they're having to close your eyes to do it, everybody have to close their eyes to use their imagination?
I don't have to, but it's easier to close my eyes and, like, do stuff than it is to, like, not.
Let me ask you this.
Really?
Do you fuck your wife with your eyes open?
No, they're open. I use those things that make the spider clamps that keep your
lips. In a pinch, you can use, like, that thing on the Ace bandage, you know, like that thing. Yeah. But
and then I'm like, hold on, my eyes are dry. Gotta use drops.
I'm like, baby, I'm gonna make love to you so good tonight. Let me go tape my eyes open first. Like, tape them up and then tape them down.
Well, do we find the new sitting standing? Are there some men that...
Do you jack off with your eyes open or eyes closed. Call in now.
Yeah, I think eyes open all the time.
I think when
I'm nervous.
I think when I reach the finish line, I'll say, I think I do close my eyes.
Okay, yeah,
but
yeah,
then I do open them real fast to make sure I'm getting it in the toilet.
There's not blood in it.
Well, no. I'm not worried about that.
No, but I feel like to use your imagination, closing your eyes.
Question,
is not
and you tell me if this is too far. Sitting, doing my business, into the toilet, right? Into the toilet.
Is that what's happening?
No, just hear me out and say if this is wrong or not. Right. Maybe I have the order wrong. Sitting, jacking, into the toilet, look in the toilet, then wipe.
Were you pooping?
Because I was pooping too.
No, God, man. That's something.
Is that bad?
That's a different level animal.
You don't shit. You don't shit where you jack.
It's two separate.
I jack on top of the shit. No. Jack and then shit. I
snow
shit.
Cat mountain.
No, jack. That's an animal. Does that? It's like,
By the way, the first one's better.
What? Jack than shit.
Yeah, right.
Yeah. At this point,
yeah, I do have it
in
wrong.
Time, and yeah,
I'm new at this.
One more. Yeah, let's do one more voice.
Here we go.
Hey, Tom and Dan. This is Christian. I was just calling because I was listening to an older BDM show that I hadn't heard, and you were talking about bed frames and how
Tom broke one fucking
bad they are. When I was 7 years old, I was jumping on the bed and I slipped off, and the bed frame cut my arm from my elbow all the way up to my wrist to the bone. Lots of stitches. And so then my mom got the little rubber cover thingies and put them on there. But I decided to let you know that. Yeah, bed frames are bad. So.
All right. Whatever.
No, I just like the whole, like, yep, bed frames are bad.
A lot of stuff was more dangerous back in the day.
Yeah.
Now your IKEA, chest of drawers comes with, like, little clips that clip it to the wall so it can't fall over on the baby.
Oh, yeah, screw them in, man.
Back in the day, I was the asshole for bumping the TV stand and knocking over the TV on top of me. You know, like,
yeah.
Spanking for that shit.
You're just trying to climb a bookcase to get your dad's gun.
Yeah. Every bed frame, all the legs were shards of metal. Sharp.
It looked like the Iron Throne from Halo. It's just slashing.
Like,
you.
Why would you make this? I'm going to cut my feet. And they're like,
and
nope,
even
nope.
Now, I still stub my toes on it, and I bleed everywhere. It's it's not good.
They're like, no other option. Have to make it super dangerous. Cut your feet up.
We'll do one more, only because it's a Thanksgiving related call.
Hi guys, I'm sorry for the bad quality on this. I'm driving, but I just want to call and tell you about a new scam that just happened to me. It's Thanksgiving. And I get a call from my number. It's got my number as the ID. Said it's Verizon. And my account's been suspended. And then I got to verify it. Then they put me on hold for a minute while I got to wait for this scammer to get on. Gives me this blind shit about how my account's been suspended. And I got to verify it. Asked me for my social or my zip code, which I gave. Then he said, hey, we just texted you an 8-digit code. Verify is, give us that code, verify it. Just like when they try to get your Google number to change your number. And I was like, no, scammer, you're doing this on Thanksgiving? God, where's your soul? Get it together, scammers, it's Thanksgiving! God! Love you guys, happy Thanksgiving.
Well, most likely they're, you know, scammers from India. They don't celebrate Thanksgiving, so. Yeah.
I also like how he combines social security card into socialty card. Did you hear that?
And shout out to Chopper
Dave. My socialty card. I'm like, socialty card.
Get it together, scammers!
Call him from the chopper.
Yeah.
Ross, how many scam calls do you get a day? Because it is goddamn it's ridiculous.
Calls, not so bad, because those are usually just robots and I hang up on them. Emails, I went through a weird thing on Facebook where I would sign up for any giveaway on Facebook. just typing in your email and name and phone number or whatever. So I have my email is a goddamn trash wasteland.
Oh, yeah. You only need to give it out once.
I didn't win shit either.
Yeah. That's a good prank. If you want to really fuck with someone, just take someone's email and just go start signing up to all the pop-ups you can find.
Because
your email will be ruined for life. Like, it'll never, it gets into some system and you will never be able to stop, no matter what.
if you put like, oh, please don't email me, they don't give a fuck.
No, apparently. I swear to God, that is double down on email.
I learned that a long time ago. Unsubscribe. I try to do it. It's like,
yeah, no, you send them that unsubscribe letter, they're like, he sent a letter, double down.
Yeah, there's someone in India, like, you think we're fucking beholden to your laws? Fuck you.
Yeah.
We're going to get you in 10 times more.
Oh, he checked the box. We must not say.
Yeah, yeah. No. Like, oh, we're, you know what? We're going to follow the rules and not send them a million emails. It's ridiculous.
I actually, I reversed this the other day. I got a call and somebody wanted me to re-up my credit card information. And I was like, fuck you. Fuck you, you fucking scammer. And they're like, no, sir. This is actually your son's violin that you financed. I don't know if you remember a couple months ago when you deactivated your card and got a new card. And I was like, fuck! I'm so sorry. Please, here. My card number, my mom's maiden name, my first dog was named Ginger. Whatever you guys say.
This is Bill's violin store. Yeah. You're right.
They were like, oh, you have a bad credit card and we need to reactivate your number. I was like, fuck you. You fucking scam. You piece of shit. You're not, it's the violin. Your son's violin. I was like, oh.
Yeah, that happened with me with the my dentist's office.
I did that to my gastroenterologist. I called and I'm like, hey, bro. And they called me and I'm like, hello. This is Dr. Dennis. And oh my God, he's bleeding from his asshole. Oh, it's spray crazy. Oh, there goes his boner. And they're like, sir? Sir, Daniel? And I'm like, yeah. She goes, this is the nurse.
It's Marsha. Yeah.
This is the nurse from Dr. Schultz's office. Oh, you have an appointment on the 5th.
What is wrong with you people?
And I'm like, I will be there promptly.
Here's how you fix this problem. Never answer your phone. Always let it go to voicemail. And if it's important, they will leave a voicemail and you will call them back. Otherwise, don't fucking pick.
But I'm not built like that. Like, when my phone rings, I'm like, who is it?
No
but
way.
The problem is now, like, I miss my teeth cleaning because my dentist's office, like, I stopped.
They didn't leave you a voicemail?
They did, but I don't check it.
Well, yeah, that's exactly. On you. No,
you know
that's
up?
On you.
You know
full
up?
Of shit.
He gets his teeth cleaned by the Castleberry Santa Claus.
Oh, you looks like someone's got a root canal.
But because I never answer my phone anymore, I'm missing all the shit because.
Go through your voicemail at night.
The problem is even the scammers, they somehow they get tripped up by my voicemail.
It's a great Tom Petty song.
Yeah, and then you just hit the fucking button to delete it, go to the next one.
But it's all too full and too much stuff. God damn.
All he wants to do is watch sports, Bovada, and just pet Oreo on his lap.
All these voicemails. Anyway.
Do you need me to go through your voicemails?
Yes, I do. It's all full now.
Don't do that.
It was weird yesterday when Tom was in a cleaning mood. I was kind of freaking out. I thought something was wrong.
Was Adderall kicked in?
Yeah.
And I think he doubled his dose.
I haven't been drinking because I've been sick, so I still laid off the White Claw.
Oh, I thought you were just a bubbly guy now.
Oh, he's bubbly.
No. Maybe you
feel great, by the way. I'll be back.
Nice.
You know, I'm sweating crazy right now. I'm about to have a seizure.
Your flip-flops are half off because they're shaking all
I'm on the brink of a seizure.
You can't put them on.
And if I don't get a White Claw in me, I will die. It's a serious medical condition. Well,
are you going to do that thing you used to do every show where you slam like a six-pack of Lagunitas before you drive home?
Oh, yeah. Well, that's just to keep me normal.
Well, no, he'll do that after the show. He'll go into the lobby and then tell stories to everybody. Yes. Look at this. I know you guys will be like, yeah, we've heard it. This is just your drinking time.
So anyway, there I was jumping gravedigger.
So
say another exchange.
We're bringing it back. We're going to jump one more for 2020? I think he's got one more jump in him.
And Gravedigger's son is like doing Gravedigger.
Yeah. Right? It's a whole family.
It's son of Gravedigger.
Yeah. There's the cousins are out there. The whole Anderson's family has a bunch of Gravediggers.
Yeah, there's a new truck called I Once Met Gravedigger. It's awesome. It's incredible.
They're like Dennis Anderson's son, Cave Digger's on there.
Gravedigger.
Yeah. And then there's another one. That's it. All right, Ross, are you going to be doing stand up anywhere?
Coming up.
Oh,
yeah. Let's plug this tumbleweed.
I got a whole note card full of stuff.
Yeah, do it.
The Orlando Talk Show with Ross McCoy. Hashtag Talks with Ross. Oh, we got a sponsor now. Mo DeWitt is sponsoring the show.
Yay! That's awesome. Mo's my sponsor.
We love Mo.
Paying for some of my weed every month. All right, and every first and third Saturday at the Bull and Bush, I'm doing comedy. Oh, don't forget, tomorrow is 12/7. That's the first Saturday of the month, so we got a show at the Bull and Bush.
Nice.
And that is going to be the official site for Toys for Tots with Ross for Toys for Tots. Bring a new unwrapped toy to me at the Bull and Bush tomorrow, and I'll make sure it gets to Toys for Tots. Toys for Tots with Ross for Toys for Tots. And then at the Bull and Bush every Wednesday is an open mic. I know, Tom, you've been trying out some material there at the open mics. You've been working on your stuff. Mm-hmm. You didn't know that. I knew that was you under the fake mustache. I've been clocking that. Yeah. And then next Wednesday, the 11th, we got a special show at the Bull and Bush at 9:30. We're bringing a producer out from L.A. who books for shows like America's Got Talent, stuff like that. And we're going to do an industry showcase. We got like 30.
The lineup is insane. And I've commented, I think, on like on two different, like when Ross throws the lineup up, like of names, like locally and non-local, that are like big name, hilarious fucking comics.
Yeah, yeah.
It's the most stacked deck I think I've ever seen.
It's everybody that me and you guys remember, Abby Stass, and used to write for The Weekly, comedian from Chicago, lives in Orlando here now. Me and her both put our two lists together of like, I think we both put together our 20 favorite comedians, a bunch of overlap, whatever was left, and who could make it. It's like 30-something comedians.
That's a lot of people.
Everybody's going to be doing two-minute sets, which is kind
that's
of a,
awesome.
It's kind of a standard New York, L.A. thing, but you don't see it a lot around here. So it's going to be people performing in an industry showcase type setting.
Cool.
For to be seen for talent, basically.
Cool.
So that's going to be a fun show. If you're on Xbox, add me, Plum Artifact 905. I'm playing Fortnite all day, every day. And check out the Cranberry song, When You're Gone. It's a really good song.
Really?
It's a really fucking good song.
When You're Gone by the Cranberries?
Mm-hmm. I know a Matchbox 20 song, When You're Gone, right?
I'm going to say...
Since you've been gone, baby, it's time to come home.
Oh, yeah. This is way better.
Okay.
Yeah, probably anything's better than that.
Samantha?
Semanticspodcast.com. If you want to sign up to be a patron, you can go to patreon.com/semantics.
What would you have done if Tom right there had been like, Samantha... I love
I think they're crazy.
I've been like, you.
He's going through withdrawal. Get him a White Claw. Travis, we got some stuff going on at the Watering Holes.
Yes, actually, we got a bunch of stuff going all over the town. But Ivanhoe Park Brewing Company tomorrow from it starts at 12. They have their 12-ounce can release of Park Hopper Pilsner. It's a light, crisp Pilsner available in 16-ounce cans, draft, and limited release. Tuffy's West End and Celery is all part of the Jingle Jam, which is going on this Saturday as well from 4 to 10. There's a bunch of stuff going out there, food trucks, carnival games, and all kinds of stuff, vending. And you'll have a bunch of beer vendors out there as well. And then Sunday's my dad's birthday.
Jingle Jam's that porn that Casper Santa.
Yeah. All right.
So, yeah, that's it. Yep.
All right. Oh,
wow.
Drop the mic.
Way to fuck it up.
Sorry. Happy birthday, Travis's dad.
And of course, Bart Merrick's here. If you want to buy or sell a house,
or get to a podcast right on time, call right Bart Merrick.
He'll do it.
The Bart Merrick team, BartTheRealtor.com.
Indeed.
Him and my wife are a good business partnership. I did laugh.
Buy or sell a house with Bart Merrick and get a free Elf on the Shelf. Limited supply. While supplies
the
last.
The next two houses.
next two houses get an Elf on the Shelf.
Then I'm sure next year they're going to be like, we want the new ones. I'm like, oh, God.
Oh, we should mention that a BDM did give you a hard a flash drive to put some BDM shows on. Dan.
No, BDM did give you a hard on. Oh, I thought we were just talking about it. Yeah,
Jason Savage.
Yeah, Jason from Sony. He sponsored our headphones, our TV in here. He had a bunch of other hard drives, like flash drives that are like 16 gig plus. And he wiped them clean, made sure they're viable and perfect. And so for your soldiers, and I have a problem right now because we had a soldier send me a flash drive plus $20 that I gave Samantha. I said, hey, if you can put... He just wanted all the BDM shows on a flash drive, or at least as many as we could fit. So Samantha and I were like, great, we can do this. We looked in the letter, no address.
No address.
And then the cleaning people, I think, accidentally, because, like, you know, like, I'm disorganized, you know, like, things, paper around here.
Well, you guys
like,
didn't understand. He's special forces. You just put him on a flash drive, leave it on a desk. He'll come and get it.
Yeah, I hope so. Like,
send us your address, sir.
Send us your... I think his name is Bob.
I believe so.
I believe it's Bob. So, Bob, if you're listening, I need your address so I can send you your BDM shows. Yeah. If you're in the military or have a loved one in the military, if you want some free shows, BDM shows, I will put them on a flash drive. I'll put them in the mail, our treat to you.
Yep.
Just Dan at TomandDan.com, Sam at TomandDan.com, which is kind of our project. But for those in the military where, like, I know it's a problem. Sometimes you can't download. You don't have the bandwidth. You're in the middle of nowhere. We can get you a flash drive. You just got to email me your address. So and I don't need a flash drive anymore. Like, thanks to Jason and Sony. Yes. They kind of sponsored it. I've got like 25, 30 different flash drives in there. We're good to go. So just an address if you want free BDM shows.
Yep. And
as a podcaster also, Tots with Ross is there whenever you get back to a Starbucks with Wi-Fi. It's there. Download it to your phone.
And go get those scratch-offs on the website for Yellow Brick Road. Yeah. $5, you get a scratch-off, and you could possibly win a trip on the Tom and Dan cruise.
Yes, and we're going to do the cutoff December 18th because...
You're going to wear cutoffs?
Yes.
Well, he already is. Just
so, or whenever. There's 1,000 of them, so... we're not shipping them off when they order them. We have to ship them off all at the same time.
Right.
Because...
legalities.
Because we want...
now, let me pick out the good ones. let me just rifle through them.
Be sold.
Pick out the luckies.
And
I want number 420 for sure.
It all goes to a great cause, and Yellow Brick Road Foundation has been doing it for a while, and they do a really good job, and it's local. So if you want to help a local children's charity buy a scratch-off, you could win a cruise and some other cool
almost
stuff.
Almost 400 sold already, so get on that quick.
Okay,
Oh, my God, 20 more of the lucky ones.
1,000. And they just went on sale today. So
it got released to the BDMs first.
And when's the cutoff?
The 18th.
Or when they all, as soon as they all get sold, they'll be shipped out, and we'll find out who's going
to
win.
And I don't know if you're aware, Tom. I think you said 100% of the proceeds go to Yellow Brick Road Foundation. Mm. 1% does actually go to Juan to make a better mashed potatoes recipe. Legally, you should.
They're so good.
A little bit of vinegar.
All right, guys. Thank you very much, and we'll see you next week.
Wait a minute. I can't publish that. It's mediocre.
And now it's time for the Tom and Dan end of the show footnotes. Today you heard music from
Rat Boys. They used to be an acoustic duo, but now they're a full-blown indie rock band. From their soon-to-be-released Printer's Devil album that you can expect in February, you heard the song Alien with a Sleep Mask On. This has like a wonderful 90s rock sound to it that I just love. Mint 400 put out a really rad little tribute to Florida's own Tom Petty. Now, from this album entitled Don't Fade on Me, you heard a wonderful little cover of the Tom Petty classic Don't Do Me Like That. So if you're a Petty fan and like you're younger, so I will say these songs skew at times a little less traditional, you might want to pick this one up. I really enjoyed it. Charger is back with a brand new single to try and melt your face off. Now, this hard rock three pieces new track is entitled Watch Your Back. It's out right now. I can only assume that a record is around the corner. So if you like hooky, heavy, but not too heavy rock and roll, you're going to love these guys. We closed out the show with a cover of Foster the People's Pumped Up. Now, dare I say that I like this version just a little bit more. Now, this artist is known as Klingande. Klingande? Here, I'm just going to spell it because it's early and I don't feel like pronouncing it right. K-L-I-N-G-A-N-D-E. I believe multi-instrumentalist, DJ, and also has sold 1 million-plus records. So I have no idea how to say that. That's your final track, and we'll see you next week.